SSC CGL grand test number 1 tier 2 so quantitative aptitude explanation so read the first question amma a milk vendor has 21 liters of cow milk 42 liters of toned milk and 63 liters of double toned milk if he wants to pack them in a can so that each can contains same liters of milk and does not want to mix any two kinds of in a can then the least number of cans required is how much okay the keyword it is same liters of milk so quantity contains the same liters of milk quantity is same size each size is same equal size that is one keyword another keyword it is least number of cans so I already explained about HCF wherever they given keywords maximize size of each group equal size of each group least number of cases whenever they are giving this type of terminology we need to apply HCF we need to apply HCF so here HCF for 21 42 63 what is the HCF amma what is the HCF 21 is the HCF so 21 is the highest common factor so each can size is 21 each can size is 21 HCF is 21 therefore each can size is 21 if each can size is 21 for first variety 21 liters na and 21 liters is nothing but each can capacity also 21 and for first variety we need one can we required one can for second variety 42 liters are there but each can capacity is 21 liters and we required two cans for second variety at the same time in the third one total 63 so each can capacity is 21 therefore I required three cans for so third variety total how many cans I required six cans I required option b is the right answer option b is the right answer question number 2 In a village, the average of young people is 42 years. But after the verification, it was found that the age of a person had been considered 20 years less than the actual age. So the new average after the correction increased by 1. The value of n is how much? Young people average is 42 years. Young people average is 42 years. After some correction, young people average is 43. Due to this correction, so in the first one, 20 years less they are counted. That is the reason plus 20. Okay, Namma? Now, so n into 42, 42 n into 43, 43 n. Difference is n. N is equal to what? 20. Therefore, number of people in that village is 20. Option B is the right answer. So this question we are going to say in another method also amma inkoka method ku cheptan chunnamma so we are going to apply t method also so original average is 42 so here correction is what 20 years less than that correction is 20 by number of people so that resultant value increased by 1 so 20 by n is equal to plus 1 therefore n is equal to 20 number of persons is 20 we are going to apply t method for correct average okay nandi so your answer is 20 option b is the right answer Question number 3 Ramya's father was 38 years of age when she was born her mother was 36 years when her brother Gopi was born Gopi is 4 years younger than Ramya so what is the difference between the ages of parents look at me amma here Ramya's father age was 38 years when Ramya was born her mother was 36 years age when brother Gopi was born Gopi is 4 years younger to Ramya therefore here Ramya to Gopi age gap is 4 years Ramya to Gopi she is nothing but Ramya so the age gap between Ramya and Gopi is 4 years at the same time here the father and wife age is what amma difference is what 2 years here 4 years difference here 2 years difference total how many years difference amma 6 years difference therefore the age gap between two parents that is nothing but father and mother is nothing but 6 years okay namma ikkada entante Ramya puttinappudu father age 38 gopi puttinappudu mother age 36 ante appudu chuste father ki mother ki oka vela iddaru kuda at a time puttaru anukunnappudiki kuda ఏజ్ గ్యాప్ 2 ఇయర్స్ ఎవరికి ఫాదర్ కి మదర్ కి కానీ గోపి ఎప్పుడు పుట్టాడు 4 ఇయర్స్ రమ్య పుట్టిన 4 ఇయర్స్ తర్వాత పుట్టాడు అంటే ఆ 4 ఇయర్స్ ప్లస్ 2 ఇయర్స్ టోటల్ ఎన్ని ఇయర్స్ 6 ఇయర్స్ దేర్ఫోర్ ద గ్యాప్ బిట్వీన్ మదర్ అండ్ ఫాదర్ ఇస్ 6 ఇయర్స్ ఆప్షన్ సి ఇస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్ क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 ए कामा बी एंड सी आर थ्री ग्लासेस कंटेनिंग वाटर एंड आल्कोहल इन द रेशियो ऑफ 1:5 3:5 5:7 इफ ऑल आर मिक्स्ड इन द रेशियो 2:3:4 फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ वाटर टू आल्कोहल सो वाटर टू आल्कोहल देयर आस्किंग व्हाट अमा वाटर टू आल्कोहल वाटर टू आल्कोहल सो इन द फर्स्ट वेसल वाटर इज वन पार्ट टोटल 6 पार्ट्स इन दैट 6 पार्ट्स वाटर इज वन पार्ट सो 1/6 From the first vessel, how many parts you are mixing? 2 parts you are mixing. 1/6 × 2. From the first vessel, you are mixing 2 parts. So, at the same time, second vessel, water is 3 parts out of 8 parts. So, 3/8. From the second vessel, how many parts you are mixing? 3 parts. Similarly, third vessel, water is 5 parts out of 12 parts. From the third vessel, you are taking how many parts? 4 parts. This is water. Okay, now coming to alcohol and from the first vessel, 5 parts of alcohol is out of 6. From the first vessel, you are taking 2. Second vessel, alcohol is 5 parts out of 8 parts. From the second vessel, 3 parts plus. So, alcohol is 7 parts out of 12 parts. From the third vessel, 4 parts. Now, 6:8:12 LCM is 24. Here also 6:8:12 LCM is 24. Yes or no? Here it is 2. Here it is 9, here it is 20, 5 4 jars, 5 2 jars 10, 5 3 jars 15, 7 4 jars 28. Now LCM is 24 na, 24 24 automatically get cancelled na, 6 4 jars 24, 4 2 jars 8, 8 3 jars 24, so 3 7, 3 9 jars 27, 12 2 jars 2 20 jars 40 is 2, LCM is 24, 24 24 get cancelled, 6 4 jars 4 10 jars 40, 8 3 jars 3 40, 315 jars 45, 12 2s are 228 jars 56. So 8 to 27 35, 35 plus 40 75, 75 is 2. So this is 85, 85 plus 56 141, 141. Therefore 25 is 2, 47. So your right answer is 25:47. There is no option. Options are wrong. So your right answer is 25:47. All of you okay, Nama? Say for example. Here, whenever they are asking question is this one, your option is 25:47. Right answer is 25:47. There is no option in the given options. Okay, Nandi? Say for example, the same question. Say for example, if the same question, if they ask another method. So, if all are mixed in the ratio 2:3:4. In place of this one, if all three vessels are equal in quantity. If all three vessels are in equal in quantity, all glasses are in equal quantity, are equal quantity. Then these three glasses are poured together in a single vessel. In that case, say for example here 1:5 now first vessel. Second vessel is 3:5 na. Third vessel is 5:7 na. 5:7 na. Now here how many parts? 6 parts. Here how many parts? 8 parts. Here how many parts? 12 parts. 6:8:12. LCM is what? 24. LCM is what? 24. So 6 how many times amma? 6 4 6 how many times amma? 4 times na. 6 4 jar na. Therefore 1:4:4. 4:5:20. 4:5:20. Here amma 24 how many times andi? 3 times na. 3 times na. So 3 3 jars 9. So 5 3 jars 15. 5 3 jars 15. Next here amma 24 na total. Total 24 na. 12 2 jars na. 5 2 jars 10. So 7 2 jars 14. Now here water is what amma? 4 9 13. 13 plus 10 23. Water is 23. The remaining is alcohol. 20 15 35. 35 plus 14 49. So 23:49. So your answer is 23:49. So if they ask question like this, if all the three glasses are in equal quantity, vessel quantity is same. In that vessel, the proportion is different, but vessel quantity, parimanam, it is same. All of you clear, andi? So vessel quantity is same. Those three equal glasses are poured into a big glass. In that big glass, so what is the ratio of water to alcohol? It is 23:49. Question number 5. Three taps A, B, C can fill a tank in 12 15 and 20 hours respectively. If A is open all the time, B and C are open for 1 hour each alternatively, the tank will be filled in how many hours? So here A alone how many amma? A alone 12. So B alone how many amma? B alone how many andi? 15. C alone 20. First of all, I need to find out tank capacity. Tank capacity is nothing but LCM. LCM of these three, 12, 15, 20. LCM is what? 60. LCM is 60. 12, how many times amma? 5 times. 15 fours are, 23 zars. Okay, namma. So the A is open all the time, but B and C are working alternatively. So first hour A and B working. First hour A and B working. Next hour A and C are working. Like that. If A and B are working, 9 liters are coming now. If A and C are working, 8 liters are coming now. In one cycle, total 17 liters are coming. In one cycle. One cycle is nothing but A plus B combination 1 hour, A plus C combination 1 hour. Total 2 hours. In 2 hours span, total how many liters are coming? 17 liters are coming. Like that, how many 17s are possible in 60? Definitely 3 17s are possible now. So we need to go for 3 cycles. 3 cycles is nothing but 3 cycles is nothing but 3 cycles is nothing but 6 hours. 3 cycles is nothing but what am I? 6 hours. In 6 hours, 17 into 3, 51 now. 17 into 3, 51 now. So 51 liters are there in the tank after 6 hours. Next, who will come? Again, A plus B come now. If A plus B is coming, so 1 hour A plus B 9 now. Yes or no? This is 7th hour now. Seventh hour, 9 liters are coming. In 6 hours, 51 liters are coming. Total how many hours amma? 7 hours. Total 60 liters fill. So option C is the right answer. So first hour A plus B work, second hour B plus A plus C work. So 9, 8, 17. And cycles 3 untai. 4 ఉండడానికి పాసిబిలిటీ లేదు 3 ఉంటాయి అంటే 3 సైకిల్స్ లో 51 లీటర్స్ వస్తాయి 3 సైకిల్స్ లో 51 లీటర్స్ వస్తాయి దాని తర్వాత మళ్ళీ ఏ ప్లస్ బి నే రావాలి ఏ ప్లస్ బి వస్తే 1 అవర్ లో 9 లీటర్స్ మనకు కావాల్సింది 9 లీటర్సే అంటే 6 అవర్స్ తర్వాత 1 అవర్ వస్తే సరిపోతుంది అంటే టోటల్ 7 అవర్స్ ఆప్షన్ సి ఇస్ ది రైట్ ఆన్సర్ సో సైకిల్ అంటే 2 అవర్స్ అండి 3 సైకిల్స్ అంటే 2 అవర్స్ బికాస్ సో ఏ ప్లస్ బి 1 అవర్ ఏ ప్లస్ బి 1 అవర్ ఏ ప్లస్ సి 1 అవర్ టోటల్ 2 అవర్స్ 3 సైకిల్స్ అంటే 6 అవర్స్ Question number 6. 3 men step off together from the same spot. Their steps measure 63 cm, 70 cm and 70 cm respectively. The minimum distance each should cover show that all can cover the distance in complete steps. So they're asking the minimum distance each should cover. So now I need to find out LCM of these three. So 63, 70. Amma, 60, I need LCM for 63, 70, 77. Look at me and 63, 70. Which table goes maximum? 7 table goes maximum. Smallest number goes how many times? Amma? 7, 9 jars. So 9 into 70 is how much and 630. Now 630 into 77. Which table goes maximum? So 7 table. Smallest number goes 11 times. 11 times of 630. So 10 times of 630 is nothing but 6300. 6300 plus 630. So 6300 plus 630, 6930. 6930. So your answer is option C. Option C is the right answer. 11 into 630. 10 times is nothing but 6300. 6300 plus 300 plus 630, 930. 6930. Option C is the right answer. సో 6000 టోటల్ డిస్టెన్స్ అంటే ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఏమో 10 స్టెప్స్ వేస్తాడు సెకండ్ వన్ ఏమో 9 స్టెప్స్ వేస్తాడు థర్డ్ వన్ ఏమో 6 స్టెప్స్ వేస్తాడు ఓకేనమ్మా లైక్ దట్ సో కంప్లీట్ స్టెప్స్ ఓకేనండి ఏ అండ్ బి వర్క్ ఇండివిజువల్ ఇన్ 24 డేస్ అండ్ 30 డేస్ రెస్పెక్టివ్లీ వర్కింగ్ 10 అవర్స్ డే వర్క్ ఈస్ టు బి డన్ ఇన్ 2 షిఫ్ట్స్ మార్నింగ్ షిఫ్ట్స్ లాస్ట్ ఫర్ 6 అవర్స్ అండ్ ఈవినింగ్ షిఫ్ట్ లాస్ట్ ఫర్ 4 అవర్స్ అండ్ ద ఫస్ట్ డే ఏ వర్క్స్ ఇన్ ద మార్నింగ్ షిఫ్ట్ అండ్ బి వర్క్స్ ఇన్ ద ఈవినింగ్ షిఫ్ట్ నెక్స్ట్ డే ఏ వర్క్స్ ఇన్ ద ఈవినింగ్ షిఫ్ట్ వైల్ బి వర్క్స్ ఇన్ ద మార్నింగ్ షిఫ్ట్ అండ్ సో ఆన్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ దట్ దే వర్క్ ఆల్టర్నేటివ్లీ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు దర్ షిఫ్ట్స్ డస్ దే వర్క్ ఆన్ దిస్ ప్యాటర్న్ టిల్ ద వర్క్ ఈస్ కంప్లీటెడ్ అండ్ విచ్ డే ద వర్క్ గాట్ కంప్లీటెడ్ సో ఏ హౌ మెనీ డేస్ అమ్మా 24 డేస్ B, how many days? 30 days. A is working for 10 hours. So both are working for 10 hours per day. So here they given in terms of days. I am going to convert it in terms of hours. A alone working for So 24 days per day, 10 hours. Therefore, A alone finish the work in 240 hours. So B alone work, B alone can complete the work in 30 into 10, 300 hours. So A alone 240 hours, B alone 300 hours. First of all, what is the LCM? LCM is nothing but 24, 30. LCM is 120. That is nothing but 1200 hours. So 240, how many times amma? 5 times. 300, how many times amma? 4 times. Therefore, A 1 hour work is 5 units, B 1 hour work is 4 units. Okay, namma. Now who started the work? So morning shift is nothing but 6 hours, evening shift is nothing but 4 hours. So on the first day, A is working in the morning shift. A morning shift. Morning shift, how many hours amma? 6 hours. A 1 hour, how much work amma? 5 units. 6 into 5. Plus on the same day, B evening shift. Evening shift, how many hours amma? 4 hours. B's 1 hour work is how amma? 4. One day, that is nothing. First day, A morning shift 6 into 5. On the first day, B evening shift 4 into 4. That is nothing but 6 5s 30. 4 4s 16. 16 plus 30, 46. And amma? 46. So this is first day. This is what amma? First day. This is first day. First day. Second day. Second day. Plus second day. Second day, who will come? B in the morning shift, A in the evening shift. B in the morning shift na? So B in the morning shift. B morning shift. Morning shift, how many hours? 6 hours. But B's work is 4 units. So on the same day, on the second day, A is in the evening shift na? Evening shift, how many hours? 4 hours. But 1 hour A's work is 5 units. 5 units. So this is what amma? Second day. This is what amma? Second day. Second day. So first day, A morning shift, B evening shift. Second day, B morning shift, A evening shift. In this pattern, whole work we need to complete. So here, what amma? First day, 46 units. Second day, 24, 20. How much amma? 44. 44. Therefore, here, this entire thing I am going to assume as one cycle. First day, 46. Second day, 44. Again, third day, this pattern is coming now. Fourth day, this pattern is coming now. Like this, 2 days is one cycle. 2 days is one cycle. So one cycle, 46 to 44. How many units are completed? 90 units are completed. In one cycle, 90 units are completed. In 1200, how many 90s are possible? How many 90s are possible? So amma, 9 table, 1200, 120, any times both amma? How many cycles are? 13 cycles are possible because 39s are 117. 13 cycles into 13 cycles. Amma, 13 cycles is nothing but 13 cycles is nothing but each cycle is 2 days na. Therefore 26 days. Therefore 26 days. After 26 days, so 13 days into 13 cycles. 13 into 90. 13 into 90, 1170. 1170 units gone. Remaining work is what? 30 units. Next, who will come? After completion of the cycle, next who will come? Again, A in the morning shift na. So 27th day, A is in the morning shift. A morning shift. So how many hours amma morning shift? 6 into 5. 6, 5 is 30. I need to complete 30 units only. This is which day? 27th day. This is which day? 27th day. 27th day. So 27th day. 27th day. So 30 units completed. Up to 26 days, 1170 units are gone. So on which day, they're asking, on which day the whole work completed. So on which day, Andy? 27th day. Option B is the right answer. Question number 8. A, B and C can do a job in 60 days, 12 days and 15 days respectively. After 1/8 of the work is completed. C leaves the job, rest of the work is done by A and B together. The time taken to finish the remaining work. They're asking what remaining work. So first of all, A alone how many days amma? A alone 6 days. B alone how many days amma? B alone 12 days. C alone how many days amma? C alone 15 days. So total work is nothing but 6 to 12 and 15. Total work is 60. LCM is 60. 6 tens are. So 12 fives are. 15 fours are. Okay. So total work is 60. They are asking question is what? They are asking remaining work. How much work is completed? 1/8 of the work is completed, then C leaves. After 1/8 of the work is completed, C leaves. So 1/8 of the work is completed. Remaining work is what? 7/8 na? Remaining work is what? 7/8 na? 7/8 of total work is 60. Total work is 60. 7/8 of 60. 7/8 of 60 is the remaining work. That one is completed by whom? That one is completed by whom? A and B na? A and B one day work is what? A and B one day work is what? 15. So 10 plus 5, 15. Okay, namma? So 15 fours are, 4 ones are, 4 twos are. So 7/2 is nothing but 3.5 days. So it will take 3.5 days to complete the remaining work. They are asking only remaining work. So option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. So 1/8 of the work is completed. After that one, C leaves. All of you clear, Andy? Remaining work is 7/8. 7/8 of 60. So that remaining work is done by A and B together. A and B together is 10 plus 5, 15. So 15 ones are, 15 fours are, 4 ones are, 4 twos are, 2 3.5 are 7. So your answer is 3.5 days. Option C is the right answer. Question number 9. So during our campaign against child labor, we have found that in 3 ice making factories A, B, C, there were total 33 children aged below 18 years involved. So below 18 years. So were involved. The ratio of male to female, the ratio of male to female in ABC was 4:3, 3:2, and 5:4. So respectively, if the number of female children working in the factories B and C be equal, then find the number of female children so working in the factory A. This is very easy question. If you see the logic, they're asking question is what? First of all, question is what? Find the number of female children working in factory. Female children working in factory A. So factory A ratio is what? Factory A male to female ratio. They given male to female ratio na? Male to female ratio. So male is 4 parts. Female is 3 parts. They're asking factory A females are how many? Definitely your answer should be multiple of 3 na. See the options. Multiple of 3 which option is there. Option D is the right answer. Nika logic telsa ledanna identify chestunnadante. Ala clear andi. So in factory A they are asking female working. Okay namma, female working. So first of all, in company A, factory A, how many female parts are there? Female parts are 3. Therefore, number of female also in multiple of 3. Na? So, see the options in multiple of 3. Which option is there? Option D is the right answer. That is a straight away answer. Question number 10. A right circular cylinder tunnel of diameter 2 meters and the length of 40 meters is to be constructed from a sheet of iron. So, the area of the iron sheet required in square meters is how much? So, look at me, Amma. Area of the iron sheet. So iron sheet required is nothing but that will be equivalent to curved surface area of the cylinder. Simple, I can say curved surface area of the cylinder. Because ఎప్పుడైనా చూడండి అమ్మా, ఒక సిలిండర్ తీసుకుంటే ఆ సిలిండర్ ని ఏదైనా మెటీరియల్ తో ప్రిపేర్ చేస్తే సిలిండర్ వాల్యూమ్ లో మనం ఆ మెటీరియల్ ని యూజ్ చేయం. ఆ సిలిండర్ కావాల్సినటువంటి కర్వ్డ్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏరియాలో మాత్రమే ఆ మెటీరియల్ మనం యూజ్ చేస్తాం. అంటే మెటీరియల్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు కన్స్ట్రక్ట్ ఏ సిలిండర్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ద కర్వ్డ్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ద సిలిండర్. All of you clear and remember that one. Now I need to find out curved surface area of the cylinder. So curved surface area of the cylinder is nothing but 2πRH. So 2πRH. So here, diameter 2 meters. Therefore, radius is what? 1 meter. Length. Length is nothing but height. Height is equal to 40 meters. Height is equal to what? 40 meters. Now, so 2 into pi into the options are in terms of pi. Pi into r is 1. So pi h is 40. Therefore, your answer is what? 80 pi. So option B is the right answer. Remember one point, all of you. The material required to prepare a cylinder is nothing but the curved surface area of the cylinder. Question number 11. Harsha buys 4 horses and 9 cows for 13,400. If he sells the horse at 10% profit and the cow at 20% profit, so then he earns a total profit of 1880. The cost of the horse is dash. Here, 4 horses plus 9 cows, 13,400. So look at me, all of you. 4 horses plus 9 cows. Together is 13,400. Together is what? 13,400. And they given, he sells a horse at 10% profit. One horse, 10% profit. Total, how many horses? 4 horses. One horse, 10% profit. 4 horses is nothing but 40% profit. Na? 40% is, I am going to return 2/5 of each. 2/5 of each. 2/5. 40% is. Because 1/5 is nothing but 20%. 2/5 is nothing but 40%. Plus, each horse. Each cow at 20% profit. Each cow at 20% profit. So, one cow at 20% profit. 20% is nothing but 1/5, na? One cow, 1/5. Total, how many cows? 9 cows. Total, how many cows? 9 cows. So, one cow, 1/5. 9 cows, 9/5. 9/5 of C. In this way, he is getting how much profit, amma? 1880. He is getting how much profit, amma? 1880. This 5 goes to that side. So, what we are getting, Andy? 2 times of horse plus 9 times of cow is equal to. So, 5, 8, 18 jars. 5, 18 jars, 9,000. 5, 8 is as 400. 9,400. 9,400. Now, I need a horse. Now, I need what am I? Horse. They are asking cost of horse is how much? Cost of horse. So, if I cancel, Andy, So, 2 horses is equal to, 2 horses is equal to cow, cow get cancelled. So, 4,000. 2 horses is equal to 4,000. Then each horse is what am I? 2,000. Each horse is what am I? 2,000. Each horse is 2,000. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. All of you clear, Andy? So, option B is the right answer. Question number 12. A person spends 40% for food, 20% of the remaining amount of rent, and 37.5% of the remaining amount for entertainment, 10% of the remaining amount for convenience, and 40% of the remaining amount for his PhD. His savings were 3,645. So, and find his monthly salary. Find his monthly salary. Find his monthly salary. So, look at me and all of you. Look at me and all of you. So, I don't know, first of all, how much monthly income. I assume as 100. 40% for food. 40% for food. So, 40% of 100, 40. So, 40 rupees food. Remaining is what am I? 60. Remaining is what am I? 60. 20% of the remaining. They said the remaining. That is very, very important. 20% and remaining. 20% and 60. 20% and 60 is nothing but what am I? 12. Therefore, remaining is what am I? 48. Remaining is what? 48. On that remaining, again, 37.5%. Am I 37.5 until we know very well that is 3/8. So, 1/8 is nothing but 12.5. 3/8 is nothing but, so 37.5. 3/8. 3/8. 8 1s are 8 6s are 6 3s are 18. So, 3/8 of 48 is nothing but 18. 8 1s are 8 6s are 6 3s are 18. The remaining is what am I? 30. The remaining is what am I? 30. So, remaining amount. Okay. And 10% of the remaining convince. 10% of the remaining. 10%. 10% of 30. 10% of 33. The remaining is what? 27. The remaining is what? 27. Again, 40% of the remaining on for PhD work. 40% of the remaining. So 40%. Amma 10% is 2.7. 10% is 2.7. 40% is nothing but 4 into 2.7. So 4 into 2.7. 4 2s are 8. 4.7 is 2.8. 2.8 plus 8. 10.8. 10.8. If I subtract 10.8, amma, first of all, if I subtract 10, that should be, so 17. Na. If I subtract 0.8, so 16.2. 16.2. If I subtract 10, 17. 17. 17 launch 0.8 in this 0.2. 16.2. This is the remaining. This is the saving. This is what? Saving. If your monthly salary is 100, if your monthly salary is 100, then your saving is 16.2. So, but according to our problem, your saving is what? 3645. 3645. So, how many times it goes? How many times it goes? Exactly that many times it goes. So, any times both check charts now. No need to check. Because look at me here. This is 16. This is 36. 16 twos are 32. And more than 2 times. More than 2 times. Your answer is also more than 20,000. So 16 ones are 16. 16 twos are 32. But this is 36. Your answer is more than 20,000. See the options, more than 20,000. More than 20,000. More than 20,000. Only one option is there. So option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. If you want answer, 16.2, how many times it goes? 225 times it goes. So 225 times of 100. 225 times of 100. So 225 times of 100 is nothing but 22500. So your option is option D. Option D is the right answer. So if you solve in this manner, it is very easy to attack. Question number 13. A man ate 100 apples in 5 days. Each day he ate 6 more apples than those he ate in earlier days. So how many apples did the man eat on the first day? So each day he ate 6 more apples than previous. Okay, Namma. So first day, here I go through options and first day, say for example, if I ate 12, second day 18, plus 6, 24, plus 6, 30, plus 6, 36. So total 5 days. So but if we add 24 plus 36, 60 plus 30, 90 plus 18, 108. More than 100. It's not possible because only 100 apples are there. So first day it's not 12. Less than 12 and very closer to 12. Less than 12, very closer to 12. Which option is there? Only option B. Option B is the right answer. No need to check. If I take 12 is the first day, I am getting 108, approximately I am getting 120, but only 100 apples are there. So that is the reason my answer is less than 12, very closer to 12. So your answer is 8. So if you want check. If first day 8, second day plus 6 now 14, third day 20, next day 26, next day 32. If I add now 8 plus 32, 40, 14 plus 26, 40, 40 plus 40, 80, 80 plus 20, 100. Total it is 100. In the exam, no need to check. In the exam, we are going to attack directly. Work option this kun check soon, sir. 12 is kunta manak 120 wasne. So it's not possible because only 100 apples are there. So our answer is less than 12, very closer to 12. That is your answer. So option B is the right answer. A contractor undertakes to do a piece of work in 40 days. He engages 100 men at the beginning and 100 more after 35 days and complete the work in stipulated time. If he had not engaged the additional men, how many days behind the schedule would it be finished? Look at me, all of you here. So if you observe carefully, you will get the answer immediately. So here, initially, a contract work is there. That work is finished in 40 days. He engages 100 members. At the beginning, 100 more after 35 days. So up to 35 days, only 100 members are there. The existing workers are there. Our target is to finish the work in 40 days. After 35 days is nothing but 36th day to 40th day, only 5 days. Those 5 days only, the extra 100 members are working. If you not engage, the existing 100 members, they work for 5 days more. Therefore, how many days behind the schedule? 5 days. Option C is the right answer. Marla cheptunnanu chudamma, 100 members unnaru, 40 days target. 35 days varaku kuda ee 100 members work chesaru. 35 days tarvata ante 36th day nunchi 40th day varaku oka 100 members extra work chesaru. Ala work cheyabatti 40 days lo work ayipindi. Oka vela aa 100 members extra gen teeskarakapothe unna 100 members inkoka 5 days extra chesthe saripothundi. Ante enni days back schedule padutunnamma? 5 days. 5 days late avutundi. So your answer is 5 days. All of you clear andi? Straight away your answer is 5 days is that answer. Question number 15. An isosceles right angle triangle is inscribed in a semicircle of radius 7 cm. The area of the enclosure by the semicircle but exterior to the triangle. So semicircle. An isosceles right angle triangle is inscribed in a circle. Of radius 7. So for example, this is A. This is B. This is center. We know one point here. In semicircle, the angle must and should be right angle. This is 90 degrees. Okay, Amma, this is 90 degrees. So radius is how much, Amma? Radius is 7. If radius is 7, AB is 14. Radius is 7, AB is 14. Base is 14. They're asking the remaining portion. This portion. They're asking the shaded region. So first of all, I need to find out the area of the semicircle minus the area of the triangle. Then I will get area of the shaded region. Area of the semicircle is nothing but what, Amma? Half into pi r square. So 22 by 7 into pi r square. R is what, Amma? 7. 7 into 7 minus. So area of the right angle triangle. So here, whatever it may be. This is the radius, na? Therefore, this is 7, na? base is 14, height is 7. Base is 14, height is 7. Therefore, half into 14 into 7. Half into 14 into 7. Two 7s are 14. 7, 7 get cancelled. Two 11s are 77 minus 49. 77 minus 49. So your answer is what amount? 28. The shaded region is nothing but 28. The shaded region is nothing but what amount? 28 square centimeters. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 16. The base of a right prism is an equilateral triangle of side 8 centimeters and height of the prism is 10 centimeters. Then find the volume of the prism. Then find the volume of the prism. Volume of the prism is equal to area of the base into height. Area of the base into height. Here the base is look like what amma? So base is look like equilateral triangle. Base is look like equilateral triangle of side 8 centimeters. So we know equilateral triangle area. So what is the area of the equilateral triangle? Root 3 by 4 into a square. Here a is what amma? 8 into 8. Height of the prism is what amma? 10 centimeters. Height of the prism is 10 centimeters. 4 1s are, 4 2s are. So 2 8s are 16, 16 10s are 160. So 160 root 3. Therefore, volume of the prism is equal to 160 root 3. 160 root 3. Option B is the right answer. Question number 17. If y is equal to 5 minus cube root of 25 minus cube root of 5, then find the value of y cube minus 15 y square plus 60 y plus 40 is equal to how much? So here 5 comes to this side, y minus 5 is equal to, if I take minus common, so 5 to the power of 2 by 3 plus 5 to the power of 1 by 3. Now I go for cubing on both sides. So y cube minus 125 minus 3 into 5 into y minus 5. Is equal to minus cubing kabatti minus vastundi. So 5 2 by 3 whole cube is nothing but 5 square plus 5 plus, so 5 2 by 3 that is nothing but 5 2 by 3 into 5 1 by 3, that is nothing but 5 itself into 5 2 by 3 plus 5 1 by 3. So a cube plus b cube plus 3 ab into a plus b. Now y cube, so 3 into 5 15 y square minus 15 y square, so minus of minus plus, 15 5s are 75 plus 75 y minus 125 is equal to, this is 5 square plus 5 30 minus 30. In place of this one I am going to substitute. So 5 to the power of 2 by 3 plus 5 1 by 3 is nothing but y minus 5. But minus is there na? Minus y minus 5. Minus of y minus 5. Now ma, 15 into y. Minus of plus minus minus into minus. So plus 15y. Plus 15y. Next to minus of plus minus minus half minus plus plus into minus 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 minus. So how much into 15 into 5 75. Now y cube minus 15 y square, this 15 y comes to this side minus, that become plus 60 y. This 125 comes to that side, this is minus 30 plus minus 75 minus 105 plus 105, that is nothing but 20. Now I need LHS side 40. Add 40 on both sides. Already 20 is there. If you add 40, it becomes 60. Therefore, 60. Your answer is what am I? Option B. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 18. If x by y plus y by x is equal to minus 1, x or y not equal to 0, then 2 to the power of x cube minus y cube is equal to dash. So here, if I take LCM, LCM is xy, therefore x square plus y square, this xy comes to this side minus xy comes to this side plus xy. X square plus y square plus xy is equal to 0. Now we know very well x cube minus y cube. X cube minus y cube I am going to return as x cube minus y cube I am going to return as x minus y into x minus y into x square plus y square plus xy plus xy. This part is zero, na? This part is zero, na? If this part is zero, this entire thing is zero. Here also zero. Therefore, your answer is zero. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Question number 19. If A by 1 minus A plus B by 1 minus B plus C by 1 minus C is equal to 1, then find the value of this one. So add 1 to each term of LHS. Add 1 to each term of LHS. Therefore, here plus 1. Here also plus 1, here also plus 1, add plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. If you add plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, total 3, na, add plus 3 to RHS. Therefore, no changes in the original equation. Na. Now I add plus 1 here, plus 1 here, plus 1 here, I add plus 3 here. Now, so if you take LCM, 1 minus A is the LCM, 1 minus A plus A by 1 minus A plus 1 minus B plus B by 1 minus B plus C plus 1 minus C by 1 minus C is equal to 4. Is equal to 4. Now, Amma, cancel A, B, B, C, C. Then remaining thing is what? Remaining thing is what? 1 by 1 minus A, 1 by 1 minus B, 1 by 1 minus C is equal to 4. So your option is what? Option D. Option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. All of you okay, Namma? Add 1 for each term in LHS side. Total 3, na, add 3 in RHS side. Question number 20. The greatest of root 2, 6, root 3, 3 root 4 and 4th root 5. So root 2. Here, Namma, root 2 I am going to written as 2 to the power of 2 whole to the power of 1 by 2. Next, 6th root 3. 6th root 3 I am going to written as 3 whole to the power of 1 by 6. Next, cube root 4. Cube root 4 I am going to written as 4 whole to the power of 1 by 3. 4 whole to the power of 1 by 3. Next, 4th root 5. 4th root 5 I am going to written as 5 whole to the power of 1 by 4. 5 whole to the power of 1 by 4. Whenever they are asking this type of questions, first of all, take LCM for these denominators. 2, 6, 3, 4. LCM is 12. LCM is what? 12. Multiply 12 with each term. Multiply 12 with each power. Multiply 12 with each term. Now what happened? So 2 power 6. This is 6 2s as 3 square. 3 4s as 4 to the power of 4. 4 3s as 5 to the power of 3. Which one is the highest one? 5 cube is 125, but 4 to the power of 4 is 256. This value is 256. This is the highest one. 256, 3 square 9, 2 power 6 is very less. That is nothing but 256. So 4 to the power of 4, that is nothing but cube root 4. Cube root 4 is the greatest one. Smallest one it is 6th root 3. All of you clear and D. So option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Now read question number 21. A tank has two inlet pipes which can fill the empty tank in 12 hours, 15 hours working alone, and one outlet pipe which can empty the full tank in 8 hours working alone. The inlet pipes are kept open for all the time. Outlet pipe was open after 2 hours for 1 hour. So and then again closed for 2 hours, again opened it for 1 hour. This pattern of outlet pipe continued till the tank got completely filled. In how many hours the tank has been filled working on this pattern? So here 3 taps are there. A alone how many hours amount? 12 hours. B alone how many hours amount? 15 hours. C alone how many hours? 8 hours. Here A and B are the filling taps. C is the empty tap. C is the empty tap. So what is the LCM and D? What is the LCM? LCM is 60. LCM is what? Not 60. So LCM is 120. LCM is 120. LCM is 120. Yes. LCM is 120. 12 to 15 LCM is 60. 68. It goes 4 table maximum. 62 is 120. So plus 10 from A pipe. From B pipe plus 8, from C pipe minus 15. These are the efficiencies. Now the inlet pipes are kept open for all the time, but outlet pipe is open for 2 hours per every 1 hour. Underline this one, Amma. For every 2 hours C is open for 1 hour. That is nothing but here after 2 hours C is working for only 1 hour. That is nothing but for every 3 hours C is working for only 1 hour. For every 3 hours, C is working for only one hour. That is nothing but 3rd hour, 6th hour, 9th hour, 12th hour, like that. So 3 hours I am going to consider the cycle, because first 3 hours work will be equivalent to next 3 hours work. Okay, Namma? So 3 hours. సో ఏ అండ్ బి కంటిన్యూస్లీ ఓపెన్ నా 10:08-18 1 hour 18 3 hours ఇన్ నథింగ్ బట్ 54 3 hours ఇన్ నథింగ్ బట్ 54 ఏ అండ్ బి ఇన్ 3 hours టైమ్ 3 hours ఐ కన్సిడర్ ఎస్ సైకిల్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఇన్ 3 hours టైమ్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఇన్ 3 hours టైమ్ ఇన్ 3 hours టైమ్ హౌ మచ్ అండి 18 into 3 54 సి ఈజ్ ఎంటీ పైప్ నా మైనస్ సి సో 3 hours ఓన్లీ 1 hour దట్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ -15 Look at me, Amma. So difference is what 39. Difference is what 39. In 3 years time, in 3 hours time, so net result is 39. Next three hours also net result is 39. Next 3 hours also net result is 39. Ma 39, 117. But my target is 120. Remaining is what? 3. So after 9 hours, 10th hour is coming na. So my remaining letters are how many? 3 letters. So but 10th hour only A and B are working because C is not there. C is working 3rd hour, 6th hour, 9th hour, 12th hour. But 10th hour only A and B are there. A and B efficiency is what? 18. So 3/18. So 3/18 is nothing but 1/6th of the hour. 1/6th of the hour is nothing but 10 minutes. After 9 hours, after 9 hours 10 minutes after 9 hours 10 minutes so 10 minutes plus 10 minutes plus 9 hours 10 minutes your option is option c is the right answer option c is the right answer all of you clear andi so 3 hours 9 hours so remaining 3 letters it will take 10 minutes so 9 hours 10 minutes option c is the right answer Question number 22. The driver of an ambulance sees a school bus 40 meters ahead of him. After 20 seconds, the bus is 60 meters behind. The speed of ambulance is 30 km per hour. So what is the speed of the bus? So here, if you observe, Amma, initially 40 meters ahead of him. After 20 seconds, 60 meters behind. 40 meters ahead. 60 meters behind. Difference is what? Ahead is nothing but plus 40. Behind is nothing but minus 60. Plus 40, minus 60. Relative distance is 100 meters. After how many seconds? 20 seconds. Distance by time is nothing but relative speed. So relative speed is nothing but what am I here? S1 minus S2. So S1 is what? Ambulance speed, 30. S2 I need to find out. So this is meter per second. So I need to convert them into kilometer per hour. So 100 get cancelled. So 100 get cancelled is equal to 18. So S1 minus S2 is equal to 18. Therefore S2 is equal to what, Amma? 12. S2 is equal to what? 12. 12 is nothing but bus speed. So 12 kilometer per hour. So bus speed is 12 kilometer per hour. Option D is the right answer. Question number 23. Two men, A and B, start walking together to a certain distance at a speed of 183 km per hour. Another person is 3.75 km per hour. A arrives half an hour late than B. The total distance is how much? So here A and B, the walking distance is same. Distance is constant here. Whenever distance is constant, speed and time are inversely proportional to each other. Here they given speed ratio 3 km per hour, 3.75 km per hour. So 3:3.75. 7.75, 4s are, 0.75, 5s are. Speeds are in the ratio 4:5. If speeds are in the ratio 4:5, times are in the ratio 5:4. So 5 parts to 4 parts. The difference is 1 part. 1 part is half an hour. Therefore, second person take 4 parts, 4 into half an hour, 2 hours. Second person speed is 3.75 into 2 7.5. therefore distance is 7.5 kilometers. Option D is the right answer. Once again I will explain here distance is constant. Whenever distance is constant, speed and time are inversely proportional to each other. Speeds ratio is 3:3.75. So which table to cancel? 0.75 table to cancel. 0.75 4s are, 0.75 5s are. మీకు ఎలా తెలుసు సార్ 0.75 టేబుల్తో పోతుందని? సో ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ 3 and 3.75 ఇస్ 0.75. డెఫినెట్లీ ఇట్ వాస్ 0.75 టేబుల్. సో స్పీడ్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ద రేషియో 4:5, దెన్ టైమ్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ద రేషియో 5:4. సో డిఫరెన్స్ ఇస్ హౌ మెనీ పార్ట్స్ అమ్మా? డిఫరెన్స్ ఇస్ వన్ పార్ట్. వన్ పార్ట్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్. One part is half an hour. Then 4 parts is what, Amma? 4 parts is nothing but 2 hours. 4 parts is nothing but what, Amma? 2 hours. They're asking distance. Distance is nothing but speed into time. Speed is what? 3.75. Time is what? 2 hours. Therefore 3.75 into 2, 7.5 kilometers. So option D is the right answer. Question number 24. The compound interest on a certain sum of money at 5% per annum for 2 years is 328. So the simple interest on the same sum at the same time. So same rate of interest is how much? Compound interest for 2 years it is 328. Rate of interest is 5%. So first year interest is little bit lesser than second year interest. Therefore, this 328 I am going to split into first year interest is 160, second year interest is 168. Second year interest is nothing but first year interest plus interest on interest. Therefore, this 8 is interest on 160 na. 8 is how much percentage on 160 ma 5% na. Therefore, rate of interest is 5% na. Satisfied na? Yes or not? So my splitting is correct. So nen 328 ni 160 168 ga split chesa. Second year interest 168. Second year interest ante enti? First year interest 2 plus interest on first year interest. First year interest is 160, second year interest is 160 plus 8. That 8 is interest on 160. 8 is how much percent on 160? 5% na. All of you clear andi? So if first year compound interest is 160, first year simple interest is also 160, second year simple interest is also 160. In simple interest every year interest is same. Therefore, 2 years interest, 2 years simple interest is what? 320. Therefore, 2 years SI. So 2 years SI is 320. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. This is one way to solve. So I will explain another method also. So here principle I don't know. I assume as 100. So first year interest amma 5% in a rate of interest 5. Second year interest is what? 5 plus 5% of 5, that is another 0.25. Therefore, 2 years compound interest is 10.25. So first year CA is 5 now. First year SI is also 5. Therefore, 2 years SI is 2 years SI. So 2 years SI is 10. So 2 years CA is 2 years CA is 10.25 according to 100, but according to our problem 328. So it goes how many times? 32 times. 10 32s as 320.25, 32s as 8. It goes exactly 32 times. 32 times of 10, 320. Therefore, your answer is what? 320. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Question number 25. A sum of money amounts to 4624 in 2 years and 4913 in 3 years. Yet compound interest. Find the sum. Here after 2 years, 4624. After 2 years is what amount? 4624. After 3 years is what amma? After 3 years is what amma? 4913. Difference is how many years and the difference is 1 year. How much interest, how much amount difference is there amma? So 289. All of you clear and the? Amma, if you observe carefully, after 2 years 4624, after 3 years 4913, 1 year interest is 289. Now I need principal. Principal is nothing but I need to go back 2 years na. I need to go back 2 years back na. 1 year interest itself 289. So 2 years interest comparatively it is less, but 2 years interest is nothing but approximately 500 to 600. If I subtract 500 to 600 from 4600, your answer may be 4000 or 4100. Nearer 4000 to 4100. See the options 4000 to 4100. Which option is there? 4096. So directly we can say confidently option A is the right answer. నేను చెప్పింది అర్థమైందమ్మా. 1 ఇయర్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ కే 289 వచ్చినప్పుడు 2 ఇయర్స్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ అంటే ఖచ్చితంగా ఒక 500 to 600 ఉంటుంది కదా. అంటే ఆ 500 to 600 దీంతో సబ్ట్రాక్ట్ చేస్తే 4600 నుంచి 500 to 600 సబ్ట్రాక్ట్ చేస్తే మీ ఆన్సర్ 4100 to 4000 మధ్య ఉండాలి కదా. సో మీ ఆన్సర్ ఆప్షన్ ఏ. రిమైనింగ్ ఆప్షన్స్ చూడబోలవు. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ క్లియర్ అండి. సో మీకు ఇంకొక వే కూడా చెప్తానండి, ఇంకొక వేలో కూడా చెప్తాను. చూడమ్మా అనదర్ వే కూడా చెప్తాను, అందర్ ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ కూడా. 1 ఇయర్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ 289 కదా. ఈ 289 దేని మీద ఇంట్రెస్ట్ అమ్మా? 289 ఈజ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఆన్ 4624 నా. ఇఫ్ యూ అబ్జర్వ్ కేర్ఫుల్లీ 289 16 టైమ్స్ 4624. సో రేట్ ఆఫ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఈజ్ 6.25%. రేట్ ఆఫ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఈజ్ వాట్? 6.25%. Therefore, principal is always in multiple of 16. This D is not in multiple of 16. C is not in multiple of 16. B is not in multiple of 16. But A is in multiple of 16. Because 16 cube is nothing but 4096. 16 cube is nothing but 4096. Definitely, it is divisible by 16. In this way also, we are going to say confidently, option A is the right answer. Question number 26. If sin x plus sin y is equal to A and cos x plus cos y is equal to B, then find the value of tan of x plus y by 2 is how much? So here, this is in the form of sin c plus sin d. This one I am going to write as 2 sin x plus y by 2 into cos x minus y by 2. This is in the form of cos c plus cos d. Okay, and this is in the form of cos c plus cos d, nothing but 2 cos of x plus y by 2 cos of x minus y by 2 is equal to b. So this is first one and this is the second one. If I write this is in the numerator and this is in the denominator, cos of x minus y by 2 cos of x minus y by 2 get cancelled. If I write this one is the numerator and this one is the denominator, this one get cancelled. And 2, 2 also get cancelled. Yes or not? Therefore, sin of x plus y by 2 divided by cos of x plus y by 2. Tan of x plus y by 2. Tan of x plus y by 2 is equal to a by b. Is equal to a by b. So your answer is what? Tan of x plus y by is equal to tan of x plus y by 2 is equal to a by b. A by b. Option C. Option C is the right answer. Question number 27. 1 minus tan a whole square plus 1 plus tan a whole square minus plus 1 minus cot a whole square plus 1 plus cot a whole square. If I so expand this one, 1 plus a minus b whole square, 1 plus tan square a minus 2 tan a. If I expand this one, plus 2 tan a minus 2 tan a plus 2 tan a get cancelled. Therefore, plus 1 plus tan square a. At the same time, here 1 minus cot square, cot a whole square. That is nothing but 1 plus cot square a. Here minus 2 cot a. Here plus 2 cot a. Plus 2 cot a minus 2 cot a get cancelled. Therefore, plus 1 plus cot square a. So here 1 plus 2 plus 2 tan square. If I take common 2, so if I take common 2, 1 plus tan square a. Here, if I take common 2, 1 plus cot square a. So, 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus tan square, 2 tan square a. Here also 2 into 1, 2, 2 into cot square a, 2 cot square a. It is satisfied, na? It is satisfied, na? Therefore, 1 plus tan square a is nothing but, 1 plus tan square a is nothing but, so if I take common 2, 1 plus tan square a into 1 plus cot square a. 1 plus tan square a is nothing but what? So secant square a. 1 plus cot square a is nothing but what? Cosecant square a. So your answer is what? 2 times of secant square a, cosecant square a. Option C is the right answer. If I take common 2, so 1 plus tan square a is nothing but secant square a, and 1 plus cot square a is nothing but cosecant square a. All of you clear, ma? So your answer is what? Option C. Option C is the right answer. Now ready the question number 28. What is the value of tan a minus sin a by sin cube a? So tan a. Tan a I am going to written as sin a by cos a. Sin a by cos a. Minus sin a. Sin cube a. Sin cube a I am going to written as sin a into sin square a. In the numerator, I take common sin a. So denominator sin a. Sin a, sin a get cancelled. Therefore, 1 minus cos a comes to the numerator, cos a by cos a is the LCM denominator, cos a into sin square a, cos a into sin square a. Sin square a I am going to written as 1 minus cos square a, 1 minus cos square a, 1 minus cos square a. Yes or not? Amma, 1 minus cos square a I am going to written as 1 plus cos a into 1 minus cos a. 1 minus cos a, 1 minus cos a get cancelled. If cos a comes to the numerator, it becomes secant a. In the numerator, 1 minus cos a cancel with 1 minus cos a. Remaining should be what? 1 plus cos a. So secant a by 1 plus cos a. Secant a by 1 plus cos a. Option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. So this one, 1 minus cos square a, I am going to written as a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b. So this a minus b get cancelled. A plus b is nothing but 1 plus cos a. Cos a in the denominator, it comes to the numerator, secant a. Secant a by 1 plus cos a. Option C is the right answer. Question number 29. If A is equal to pi by 6, B is equal to pi by 3. So 30 degrees, 60 degrees. Now, the which of the following is or correct? First statement, sin A plus sin B is equal to cos A plus cos B. Yes, this is absolutely true because sin 30 plus cos 60. Sin 30 plus sin 60. Cos 30 plus cos 60. Absolutely same. Yes or not? Sin 30 1 by 2, sin 60 root 3 by 2, cos 30 root 3 by 2, cos 60 1 by 2, root 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 2 plus root 3 by 2. Both are same. First statement is true. Tan A plus tan B is equal to cot A plus cot B. So here has the same. Nah? Tan 30 1 by root 3, tan 60 root 3, cot 30 cot 30 root 3, cot 60 1 by root 3, root 3 plus 1 by root 3 is equal to 1 by root 3 plus root 3. Both are equal. Second statement is also true. So both statements are true. So both 1 and 2 are correct. So option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Question number 30. From the top of a 10 meters high building, the angle of elevation of the top of a tower is 60 degrees and the angle of depression of the foot is 45 degrees. So find the height of the tower. Find the height of the tower. From the top of a 10 meters building. From the top of a 10 meters building. 10 meters building. Okay. So angle of depression as well as angle of elevation. So angle of elevation is what, Amma? Angle of elevation is what? Angle of elevation is what? Angle of elevation is 60 degrees. Angle of elevation is 60 degrees. Angle of depression is what, Amma? 45 degrees. Therefore, this is 45 degrees. So height of the building, it is 10. They're asking height of the tower. They're asking this one. Amma, this one is 10. This one is also 10 na, up to here. This one is also 10 na. All of you clear, Andy? Now, if I consider, say for example, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, and this is E. If I consider ABC triangle, if I consider ABC triangle, tan 45, 1 na, tan 45, 1 na, so 10, this one is also 10. If BC is 10, AD is also 10. Now apply tan 60. Tan 60 is equal to, tan 60 is equal to, what am I? DE by AD. AD is what? 10. Tan 60 is what? Root 3. Root 3 is nothing but 3.14. Root 3 is nothing but what? 1.732 into 10. So DE is equal to 1.732 into 10. Therefore 17.32. So DE is equal to 17.32. DE is equal to 17.32. 17.32 plus 10. This is 17.32 plus 10. Total 27.32. Total it is what? 27.32. 27.32. So height of the tower it is 27.32. Height of the tower it is 27.32. Option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Question number 31. At what rate percent per annum of a compound interest will a sum of money become 16 times itself in 4 years? 16 times itself in 4 years. If rate of interest is compounded annually. So total I need 16 times. Total I need 16 times. In 4 years span, compounded annually. So base I don't know, the power it is 4. In place of base, what I substitute, then I will get 16. In place of base, what I substitute in order to get 16. If I put 2, so 2 power 4 is nothing but 16 only. If I put 2, 2 power 4 is nothing but 16 only. So 2 parts become, if I assume principal is 100, amount become 200. If principal is 100, amount is 200 and double. 200. Interest is what? 100 na. This 100 rupees is interest on 100 na. 1 year na. Therefore, rate of interest must and should be 100%. Rate of interest must and should be 100%. Option D is the right answer. Ipudu manaku 16 times avali. 4 years lo. Compounded annually. So power lo 4 undali, base em undala teledu, total 16 times avali. And base em pettukunte power lo 4 unte 16 avutundi. Power lo 4 undi. Base un 2 pettukunte 2 power 4 and 16 avutundi. And 2 ante enti? Base un 2 pettunam ante double avali. అంటే ప్రిన్సిపల్ హండ్రెడ్ అనుకుంటే 200 అమౌంట్ అవ్వాలి. 200 అమౌంట్ అవుతుందంటే ఇంట్రెస్ట్ 100 రూపీస్ కదా, ప్రిన్సిపల్ 100, ఇంట్రెస్ట్ 100, ప్రిన్సిపల్ 100, ఇంట్రెస్ట్ 100. దేర్ ఫర్ రేట్ ఆఫ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఈస్ 100%. సో యువర్ ఆప్షన్ ఇస్ వాట్? ఆప్షన్ డి ఇస్ రైట్ ఆన్సర్. ఆప్షన్ డి ఇస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్. క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 32. తన్యాస్ గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్ వాస్ 8 టైమ్స్ ఓల్డర్ టు హర్ 16 ఇయర్స్ ఎగో. హీ వుడ్ బి 3 టైమ్స్ ఆఫ్ హర్ ఏజ్ 8 ఇయర్స్ ఫ్రమ్ నౌ. 8 ఇయర్స్ ఎగో వాట్ వాస్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ తన్యాస్ ఏజ్ టు దట్ ఆఫ్ గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్? So here, 8 times older to her age 16 years ago. Amma, 16 years ago, 16 years ago. So Tanya to Tanya's grandfather. 16 years ago, Tanya's age is X. Grandfather age is what, Amma? So how many times? 8 times. That is 8X. So 16 years ago, present is nothing but what, Amma? Present is nothing but what? So present is nothing but X plus, which, how many years ago? 16 years ago. X plus 16, 8X plus 16. This is present. 8 years from now, 8 years from now, 8 years from now, from now, and 8 years hence, X plus 24, here it is what? 8X plus 24. But this is what? 3 times to this one. So this must and should be equal. Therefore, 3x plus 72 is equal to 8x plus 24. So 5x is equal to 48. X is equal to what? 48 by 5. X is equal to what? 48 by 5. But they're not asking 16 years ago or present. They're asking 8 years ago. 8 years ago is nothing but present is x plus 16, 8 years ago is nothing but x plus 8. 8 years ago, 8x plus 8 is equal to x is what, am I? 48 by 5, na? 48 by 5 plus 8 by 8 into 48 by 5 plus 8. LCM is 5, 5 get cancelled. 5 8s are 40, 40 plus 40, 88 divided by, so 8 48 jars, 8 50 jars 400, 8 50 jars 400, 8 2s are 16, 384, 384 plus 40, 424. So it goes 8 table, 8 11s are 8 53 jars, so 11 by 53. 8 years ago, Tanya says to her grandmother, grandfather age is 11 by 53. So this x plus 8 to 8x plus 8 is what? 8 years ago. 8 years ago. Okay, Namma? So your answer is 11 by 53. 11 by 53 is the right answer. Question number 33. A bag consists of 60 coins of 1 rupee, 50 paisa, 25 paisa, and the monetary value in the ratio 2 is to 3 is to 1. So find the number of 25 paisa coins. So here 1 rupee coins are there, 50 paisa coins are there, 25 paisa coins are there. The value ratio is what? Value ratio is what? So value ratio is 2, 3, 1. So here 1 rupee coins value is 2. So how many rupee coins are possible? Number of coins are how many? If this is 2 rupees, number of coins are 2. If this is 3 rupees, number of 50 paisa coins is 6. If this is 1 rupee, number of 25 paisa coins are 4. So 2, 6, 4. How many, Amma? 2, 6, 4, how many andi? 12. But according to our problem, how many coins are there? 60. So 12, 5 times na? And each one into 5. Each one into 5. They are asking number of 25 paisa coins are how many? 20. Therefore, option B is the right answer. If they ask number of 50 paisa coins, 16 to 5, 15. 50, so 16 to 5, 30. 30 50 paisa coins are there. 10 1 rupee coins are there. Therefore, they are asking 25 paisa coins. Number of 25 paisa coins are how many, Amma? 20. Option B is the right answer. Kanenu, if you 2 rupees anukunna, అంటే ఇక్కడ 2 రూపీస్ అనుకుంటే నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ కాయిన్స్ ఎన్ని ఉంటాయి అంటే 1 రూపీ కాయిన్స్ 2 ఉంటాయి. ఇవి 3 రూపీస్ అనుకుంటే నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ 50 పైసా కాయిన్స్ 6 ఉంటాయి. ఇది 1 రూపీ అనుకుంటే నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ 25 పైసా కాయిన్స్ 4 ఉంటాయి. 2 ప్లస్ 6 ప్లస్ 4 టోటల్ 12. But according to our problem, 60 kinds, 12 5s are, therefore each one into 5. There 4 into 5, 20. Therefore, number of 25 paisa kinds are 20. Option B is the right answer. Question number 34. A man borrows 6,000 at 10% per annum compound interest of interest. He pays back 2,000 at the end of each year to clear the debit. The amount that he should pay to clear his dues at the end of third year is how much? They're asking at the end of the third year, how much you need to pay to clear all the dues. So here, principal is what, amma? Principal is 6,000. Principal is 6,000. Look at me, all of you. Principal is 6,000. Rate of interest is how much, amma? Rate of interest is how much, amma? 10%. Rate of interest is 10%. 10% on 6,000. 10% on 6,000 is nothing but 600. So it become what, amma? 6,600. It become what, amma? 6,600. Become 6,600. He pays how much, amma? 2,000. Na? He paid 2,000 at the end of each year. Na? He paid 2,000 rupees. Na? Therefore, remaining is what, amma? 4,600. Remaining is what, amma? 4,600. And 4,600. And 4,600. Again, 10%. Na? 10% is nothing but 460. 460. If I add 460, if I add 5,000, 5,060. 5,060. In this 5,060, you paid 2,000 na, at the end of the year. You paid 2,000. Na. So remaining is what, amma? 3,060. Remaining what? 3,060. Again, rate of interest is what, amma? Again, rate of interest is what? 10%. Na? 10% is nothing but 306. Na? 306. Na? So 306 plus, so 3,060. That is nothing but 3,366. So at the end of third year, you need to pay. You need to pay 3,000, so 366. Option B is the right answer. If you pay 3,366, so all amounts clear due. So your answer is what, amma? Option B. Option B is the, so third year lo meer 3,366 rupees pay chesthe, so me amount anta kuda due anta kuda clear aipothundi. All of you clear andi? So 3,366. Option B is the right answer. Find the greatest number which leaves remainder same in all cases and dividing the number 77, 152, 227. So find the greatest number. Find the greatest number of X, Y, Z. So case dividing the same remainder. Same remainder in all the cases. So whenever they are asking these type of questions, Amma, so your answer is HCF of X minus Y, Y minus X. There. The difference of amma, mala x minus y ante, that is not that one. Difference simply y minus x, z minus y, that is nothing but z minus x. Difference. So difference, first two numbers difference is what, amma? 75. Second two numbers, so difference is what, amma? Again 75. Z minus x difference is what, amma? 150. Therefore, HCF of 75, 75, 150. So HCF is what, amma? 75. HCF is what, amma? 75. Therefore, option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Question number 36. In a kilometer race, A defeated B by 25 meters or 5 seconds. What time will A finish the race? So A defeated B by 25 meters or 5 seconds. In terms of meters, 25 meters. In terms of time, 5 seconds. There is nothing but A will cover 25 meters distance in 5 seconds. Na? 25 meters distance in 5 seconds. Na? Yes or no? Therefore, the race is 1000 meters race. Na? So, how many times, amma? How many times? 40 times. 40 times. Therefore, 40 times of 40 times of 5. 40 times of 5. That is nothing but 200. 200. So 200 seconds, but he defeated by 5 seconds. 5 seconds, na? Therefore, your answer is what? 5 seconds. Your answer is what? 195 seconds. Your answer is what, amma? 195 seconds. Option D is the A will finish the race in 195 seconds. Question number 37. A man sitting in a train which is traveling at 50 km per hour observes that a goods train traveling in opposite direction takes 9 seconds to pass him. If the goods train is 250 meters long, find its speed. So here, man is sitting in the train, so that train is passed by the goods train. So here the length of the relative distance is nothing but length of the goods train. Length of the goods train. So length of the goods train is 280 by relative speed. Relative speed. Both the trains are in motion. Na? So here 50 km per hour. So they're asking you find its speed. So that is nothing but goods train speed. Goods train speed. So 50 plus 50 km opposite direction of 50 plus x. into these are in meters, these are in kilometer per hour. That is the reason into 5 by 18. So how many seconds it will take, amma? 9 seconds it will take. How many seconds it will take, amma? So relative distance by relative speed is nothing but time. Now I need to find out x value. Okay, amma? So 280 is equal to 280 is equal to 50 into 5, 250. Next, 5 plus 5x. 9 ones are, 9 twos are. So that 2 comes to this side, this one into 2. So 9 ones are, 9 twos are, 2 comes to this side, 560. If I subtract 250 from 560, so 250 from 560, how much andy? 270, 260, 250, 30, 560 na? 250 plus 30, 280. 310, 310 is equal to 5x. So 2 into 280, 560. If I subtract 250 from 560, that is 310. Therefore, x is equal to what? 62. Therefore, x is equal to what? 62 km per hour. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Question number 38. A man riding cycle at 12 km per hour can reach town in 4 hours 30 minutes. If he delayed by 1 hour 30 minutes at the start, then in order to reach his destination in time, so he should ride with a speed of how much? So 12 km per hour, he reach 4 hours 30 minutes. 4 hours 30 minutes. So distance is how much? Distance is how much? 12 km per hour into 4 and a half hour. So 12 fours are 48, 12 halves are 6 plus 48, 54. Total distance is 54. My target is to reach 54 kilometers in 4 and a half hour, but delayed by 1 and a half hour initially. At the start, delayed by 1 and a half hour. Therefore, remaining time is 3 hours. Na? Therefore, I need to travel the 54 kilometers in 3 hours, because total time is 4 and a half hour, but initial 1 and a half hour delay, so my remaining time is 3 hours only. So I need to travel 54 kilometers in 3 hours. So my answer is what, am I? 18 kilometer per hour. So 18 kilometer per hour. If I travel with 18 kilometer per hour, then I will reach in time. Then I will reach in time. So option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Read the question number 39. X and Y are partners in a business. X contributed 1 by 3rd of the capital for 9 months and Y received 2 by 5th of the profit. For how long Y is money used in this business? So here X and Y are there. Here X and Y are there. So X invests 1/3 of the capital for 1/3 of the capital for 9 months. Therefore, definitely Y contributes remaining 2/3 of the capital. They're asking for how many months. So this one I need. After this one, 3 ones are 3 threes are, this one, the profits are in the ratio. So Y received 2 by 5th of the profit. If Y received 2 by 5th of the profit, and out of 5 parts, total profit is 5 parts. Out of 5 parts, Y received 2 parts. Y received 2 parts. Therefore, remaining 3 parts, X received na? So total profit is 5 parts. Out of 5 parts, Y received 2 parts. So Y received 2 parts profit, then X receives 3 parts of profit. Na? Then 3 parts investment is there. 3 ones are 3 threes are. 3 parts investment is there. 3 parts profit is there. 3 how many times amma? 1 time. Na? Therefore, this one is also I need to get 1. So in order to get 1 here, amma, so I need to divide 3. So this place of question mark, I need to put 3. 3 months. If I put 3 months, 3, 3 get cancelled, then 2, 2, 1, that's 2. So, in place of question mark, I need to put 3 months. Therefore, Y contributes for 3 months. Y so invest for 3 months. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 40. In a stream, B lies in between A and C, such that it is equidistant from both A and C. A boat can go from A to B and back in 6 hours 30 minutes, while it goes from A to C in 9 hours. So, how long would it take to go from C to A? So, here, A is there, C is there, in between A and C, B is there. So B is equidistance from A to C, and A to B distance will be equivalent to B to C distance. Okay, first one, a boat can go from A to B and back. Total hours is 6 hours 30 minutes, 6 hours 30 minutes, A to B, it goes from A to B. And again, B to A. A to B plus B to A. Total time is 6 hours 30 minutes. Total time is 6 hours 30 minutes. Total time. The same time, while it goes from A to C in 9 hours. So, while it goes from A to C in 9 hours. A to C. A to C. from A to C 9 hours. From A to C 9 hours is nothing but forward journey is 9 hours is nothing but B is the midpoint na. Therefore A to B 4.5 hour. A to B 4.5 hour. B to C also 4.5 hour na. Ante forward journey from A to B is 4.5 hour. In the first case also total time is 6.5 hour. Forward journey is 4.5 hour. Therefore backward journey is 2 hours na. Backward journey is 2 hours na. Because 4.5 hour plus 2 hours. 6.5 hour na. So B to A backward journey from B to A is 2 hours. B to A distance will be equal to C to B also na. Therefore C to B backward journey is 2 hours. C to B backward journey is 2 hours. B to A backward journey is 2 hours. Total backward journey from C to A is 4 hours na. Total backward journey from C to A is 4 hours na. Therefore option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 41. A person bought some articles at the rate of 5 for a rupee and the same number at the rate of 4 for a rupee. He mixed both type and sold at the rate of 9 for 2 rupees. In this business, he suffered a loss of 3 rupees. Then find the total number of articles bought by him was. So same number. Please underline this word among all of you. Same number. I need to equate the number. So in the first case, bought is nothing but CP. But okay, some articles at the rate of five articles for one rupee. Second one at the same number at the rate of four for a rupee. But he sold is nothing but selling price. But he sold nine for two rupees. He said what? In both the cases, number should be equal. But here 5 or 4. Is it possible? It's not possible. Okay. So that is the reason. In order to equate, first of all, I go for LCM of these three numbers. 5, 4, 9. LCM is what? 180. LCM is what? So 5, 4 is 20. 29 is 180. LCM is 180. So total articles 180. 180 articles. Chudnamma. 5 articles 1 rupee na. 536 as 180 na. Therefore 180 articles is 36 rupees. 180 articles is 36 rupees. 5 articles is 1 rupee. 180 articles is how much? 536 as 136 as 36. 4 articles is 1 rupee. Then 180 articles is how much? 180 articles is how much amma? 445 as na 45 rupees. Now tell me, in both the scenarios 180 same number na. Number is same na. Now I purchased total how many? 180. I purchased total how many? 360 na. Therefore, I need to sold 360 na. Therefore, 360 articles I need to sold. So, 9 articles is 2 rupees. 940 is just 360 na. Therefore, 240 is just 80 rupees. Here, 360 articles cost price is 81 rupees. But 360 articles selling price is 80 rupees. Loss is how much andi? Loss is how much? 1 rupee. Loss is how much amma? 1 rupee. But according to our problem, loss is how much andi? 3 rupees. How many times it goes? 3 times. So for 360 articles, loss is 1 rupee. Then 3 rupees loss for how many articles? Into 3. So 360 into 3, 1080. So option B is the right answer. 360 articles sold chaste naaku 1 rupee loss vachindi kan lekka prakaram entha loss vachindamma a loss of 3 rupees 1 rupee loss raavadaniki 360 articles aithe 3 rupees loss raavadaniki enni articles into 3 so 360 into 3 is nothing but 1080 so your answer is what amma option b is the right answer option b is the right answer question number 42 a manufacturer sells an article to a wholesale dealer at a profit of 10% the wholesale dealer sells to a shopkeeper at a profit of 20% shopkeeper sells to a customer for 56,100 at a loss of 15%. So then cost price of the article to the manufacturer is how much? So here cost price of the article for the manufacturer, I don't know, I assume some 100. So manufacturer to wholesale dealer at a profit of 10%. At a profit of 10%. 10% of 100, 10. It become what amount? 110. Wholesale dealer to shopkeeper, 20% profit. So 20% of 110, 22. It become 132. It become what? 132. So shopkeeper to customer at a loss of 15%. 10% is nothing but 13.2. So 10% is 13.2, 5% is 6.6. 6.6 plus 13.2, 19.8. Loss is 19.8. If I subtract 19.8 from 132, subtract 20 simply, 112.2. So this is finally customer. So customer paid 112.2 rupees. If manufacturer, so is preparing for the article for 100 rupees. But according to our problem, so 56,100. So it goes exactly 500 times. Therefore, 500 times of 100. So 500 times of 100. So 500 times of 100, 50,000. So your answer is what? 50,000. So 50,000. So option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Question number 43. Two articles are sold at same price. Selling prices are same. So one is sold at a profit of 75% and another at a loss of 30%. What is the overall profit or loss? So here, selling prices are same. SP1 is equal to SP2. Here SP1 I assume as 100 rupees. SP2 also I assume as 100 rupees. Okay, now both are 100 rupees. I assume as 100 rupees. So first article he sold at 75% profit. Na? 75% profit is nothing but that should be 175%. That should be 175%. 175% of CP is nothing but 175% of CP is nothing but 100 rupees. 100 rupees. 100 rupees. Now I need 100% of CP is how much? 100% of CP is how much? 25 sevens are, 25 fives are. Okay, 25 sevens are, 25 fours are. 25 fours are. So 400 by 7. CP1 is 400 by 7. This one is what? CP1. Now coming to CP2. A loss of 30% is, loss of 30% is nothing but what? 70% of CP2. 70% of CP2. 70% of CP2 is equal to how much? And 100 rupees. Now I need 100% of CP is how much? 100% of CP2 is how much? 00 get cancelled. So 100 into 10, or otherwise, if you cancel 0 here, 100% of CP2 is how much? 7 into 10 is how much, Amma? Otherwise, if I cross multiply 1000 by 7. 10 into 100, 1000 by 7. This is what? 1000 by 7 is what? CP2. So total SP is what? 100. Total SP is 200. Total SP is 200. Total CP. 400 by 7 plus 1000 by 7. 1400 by 7. So total CP is... So 1400 by 7 is nothing but 200. Total CP is 200, total SP is 200. Therefore, no profit, no loss. So 1400. So 400 by 7 plus 1000 by 7. 1400 by 7 is nothing but 7200 there. So total CP is 200, total SP is 200. Your answer is no profit, no loss. Option D is the right answer. Question number 44. A can do a work in 24 days, B in 52 days, C in 164 days. They start together, but A leaves after working for 60 days, B leaves for 60 days before the completion of the work. In how many days the whole work will be completed? A alone how many days, Amma? 24 days, na? A alone 24 days, na? So B alone how many days, and D? B alone how many days, Amma? 52 days, na? So C alone how many days, and D? 64 days. C alone how many days, Amma? 64. So 24, 52. Which table goes maximum? 4 table goes maximum. 4, 6 are? So 312, 64. It goes maximum 4 table. So 4, 16 times. 16 times of 312, 2496. So total work is 2496. So 24, how many times, Amma? 24, 104 times. So 52, how many times, Andy? 52, how many times, Amma? So 250, na? 48 times. 52, 48 times 2496, 64, 39 times. 64, 39 times 2496. So now whole work is 2496. A's one day work is 104, B's one day work is 48, C's one day work is 39. Who started the work? If they started together, A plus B plus C together started. So A leaves after working for 6 days. After working for 6 days is nothing but for the first 6 days all the 3 members are there na, if all the 3 members are there 104 48 39 how much andi 48 39 87 87 plus 104 191 6 into 191 now who leaves a leaves then who are there b and c are there but I don't know b and c how many days they are working so B leaves 6 days before. B leaves 6 days before is nothing but last 6 days only C is there na. B and about 6 days mundalle vellipoyadu. And the last 6 days C matrame work chesinatte kada. C is there for last 6 days na. C's 1 days work is 39. C's 1 days work is 39. So 9 days work 6 days work is nothing but 6 into 39. 6 into 39. 639 jars is how much andi? So 640 jars 240. That is nothing but 234. 234 is completed by C alone. 6 into 191, 6, 190 times 11, 114, that is 1140 plus 6, 1146, 1146 plus 234, 1150, 1350, 1380, the remainder should be, 1116, 1116 by B and C together, B and C together is anything but 87, so here 6 days, amma, here 6 days, here 6 days 12 days plus these days so if I cancel with 2 if I cancel with 2 3 3 29s are 3 3s are 9 remainder is 2 21 7s are 3 7s are 21 remainder is 2 372 by 29 so 29 how many times amma so 12 days plus 6 plus 6 12 days plus 372 by 24 times so 12 days 12 plus 12 days so 29 12 times 10 times 290 plus 54 248 yes sir na 12 times remainder is 24 24 by 29 24 by 29 therefore your answer is what 24 24 by 29 24 24 by 29 so your option is 24 24 by 29 option B is the right answer Option B is the right answer. Question number 45. A comma B and C are inlet pipes to a tank. A can fill the tank in 3 hours and B in 4 hours while C can empty it in 1 hour. C can empty it in 1 hour. So A, B, C are opened at 3, 4, 5 p.m. respectively. Then the tank will be emptied at what time? What p.m.? So here A and B are filling pipes. A alone how many hours? 3 hours. B in 4 hours. B in 4 hours. C in how many hours? 1 hour. LCM is 12. Tank capacity is 12. 3 4s are, 4 3s are, 1 12s are. So 4 liters are coming, 3 liters are coming, 12 liters are going. At first pipe 3 p.m. kada, first pipe at 3 p.m., second pipe at 4 p.m., and third pipe at 5 p.m. So 4 p.m., 5 p.m. So 3 to 4, 3 to 4 only A pipe is there. 3 to 4 only A pipe is there. 3 to 4 p.m. only A pipe is there. 3 to 4 p.m. is nothing but 1 hour na. From 1 hour through pipe here, how many liters are coming? 4 liters are coming. 4 to 5. 4 to 5. B also open. B also open. And A is there as well as B is also there. A and B together are there. In 1 hour, if A and B are there, how many liters are coming? 4 plus 3, 7 liters are coming na. At exactly 5 p.m., total 11 liters are there in the tank. At exactly 5 p.m., total 11 liters are there in the tank. Now C is also open at 5 p.m. A is there, B is there, C is also open. In the tank itself, 11 liters are there. Now I need to empty. Finally, I need to empty. These 11 liters I need to empty by, if A, B, C are there, 7 liters are coming, 12 liters are going. 7 liters are coming, tank lo 7 liters vastunayi, 12 liters empty avutunayi. And the net result is minus 5 na? And the net result is 5 na? 11 by 5. So 11 by 5 is nothing but 5 2s are 2 hours. 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is nothing but 12 minutes. 2 hours 12 minutes. 2 hours 12 minutes. After 5 p.m. After 5 p.m. 2 hours 12 minutes. Therefore your answer is what? 7:12 p.m. After 5 p.m. it will take 2 hours 12 minutes. 1 by 5. 1 by 5th of the hour is nothing but 12 minutes. Exactly 7:12 p.m. At exactly 7:12 p.m. the tank will be emptied because here emptying pipe efficiency is more compared to filling efficiency. All of you okay nandi? Question number 46. इफ टू एक्स माइनस वाई बै एक्स प्लस टू वाई इज इक्वल टू वन बै टू दिस इज टू एक्स माइनस वाई बै एक्स प्लस टू वाई इज इक्वल टू वन बै टू देन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ थ्री एक्स माइनस वाई बै थ्री एक्स प्लस फाइव सो हियर इफ आई गो फॉर क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन फोर एक्स माइनस टू वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस टू वाई एक्स प्लस टू वाई सो हियर थ्री एक्स इज इक्वल टू फोर वाई थ्री एक्स इज इक्वल टू फोर वाई एक्स बै वै इज इक्वल टू वाट अम्मा फोर बै थ्री एक्स बै वै इज इक्वल टू वाट फोर बै थ्री फोर बै थ्री सो इन प्लेस ऑफ एक्स सब्स्टिट्यूट फोर इन प्लेस ऑफ वै सब्स्टिट्यूट थ्री देन थ्री इंटू फोर ट्वेल्व ट्वेल्व माइनस थ्री बै ट्वेल्व प्लस थ्री दट इज नथिंग बट नाइन बै फिफ्टीन नाइन बै फिफ्टीन सो नाइन बै फिफ्टीन इज नथिंग बट थ्री बै फाइव सो थ्री थ्री जार्स थ्री फाइव जार्स सो योर आंसर इज वाट थ्री बै फाइव ऑप्शन बी इज द राइट आंसर ऑप्शन बी इज द राइट आंसर क्वेश्चन नंबर 47 सिंप्लीफाई दिस इक्वेशन सिंपली आई गो थ्रू रेशनलाइजेशन अम्मा रेशनलाइजेशन सो थ्री रूट टू डिवाइडेड बाय सो दिस वन आई कैन रिटन एज रूट सिक्स प्लस रूट थ्री रूट सिक्स प्लस रूट थ्री इन द न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर रूट सिक्स माइनस रूट थ्री डिवाइडेड बाय रूट सिक्स माइनस रूट थ्री ओके माइनस माइनस फोर रूट थ्री बाय फोर रूट थ्री बाय रूट सिक्स प्लस रूट टू इंटू रूट सिक्स माइनस रूट टू बाई रूट सिक्स माइनस रूट टू प्लस प्लस रूट सिक्स बाई रूट सिक्स बाई रूट थ्री प्लस रूट टू इंटू रूट थ्री माइनस रूट टू डिवाइडेड बाई रूट थ्री माइनस रूट टू सिंपली आई एम गोइंग फॉर रेशनलाइजेशन रेशनलाइजेशन सो हियर रूट थ्री प्लस रूट रूट सिक्स प्लस रूट थ्री इंटू रूट सिक्स माइनस रूट थ्री दिस इज ए प्लस बी इंटू ए माइनस बी देयरफॉर सिक्स माइनस थ्री थ्री ना थ्री वन लुक एट अम्मा दिस वन ए प्लस बी इंटू ए माइनस बी ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर दैट इज नथिंग बट सिक्स माइनस थ्री सिक्स माइनस थ्री इज नथिंग बट थ्री 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 गेट कैंसल रूट सिक्स इंटू रूट सिक्स रूट टू इंटू रूट सिक्स रूट ट्वेल्व माइनस रूट टू इंटू रूट थ्री माइनस रूट सिक्स माइनस सो हियर रूट सिक्स प्लस रूट टू इंटू रूट सिक्स माइनस रूट टू ए प्लस बी इंटू ए माइनस बी ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर दट इज नथिंग बट फोर 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 गेट कैंसल सो रूट थ्री इंटू रूट सिक्स रूट एटीन माइनस रूट एटीन माइनस रूट एटीन माइनस ऑफ माइनस प्लस प्लस रूट थ्री रूट टू रूट सिक्स प्लस रूट सिक्स प्लस सो हियर थ्री प्लस टू इंटू थ्री माइनस टू दट इज नथिंग बट ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर डिनोमिनेटर इज वन न्यूमिनेटर इज वाट रूट सिक्स इंटू रूट थ्री प्लस रूट एटीन माइनस रूट सिक्स इंटू माइनस रूट टू दट इज नथिंग माइनस रूट ट्वेल्व माइनस रूट ट्वेल्व नाउ रूट ट्वेल्व गेट कैंसल रूट सिक्स गेट कैंसल रूट एटीन गेट कैंसल देयरफॉर आंसर इज वाट जीरो ऑप्शन डी इज द राइट आंसर ऑप्शन डी इज द राइट आंसर सिंपली गो फॉर रेशनलाइजेशन ऑल ऑफ यू क्लियर अम्मा क्वेश्चन नंबर 48 इफ एक्स इंटू वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स वाई देन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ 9 इंटू 11 then find the value of 9 into 11 similarly simply just apply here 9 into 11 in place of x into y 9 into 11 so 9 square plus 11 square minus 9 into 11 99 9 square 81 so 11 square 121 81 plus 121 minus 99 so 81 plus here amma just subtract 99 from this one 22 22 plus 81, 103. So option is what? 103. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. So subtract 99 from 121. That should be 22. 22 plus 81. 22 plus 81, 103. So option B is the right answer. Question number 49. If 1 cube plus 2 cube plus and so on 9 cube is equal to 2025, then find the value of 0.11 whole cube, 0.22 whole cube plus and so on 0.99 whole cube. So this one I am going to written as 11 by 100 11 by 100 whole cube. Yes or no? 11 by 100 whole cube. 11 into 1 by 100 whole cube. Similarly, next one I am going to written as 11 into 2 by 100 whole cube. 11 into 2 is nothing but 22. 22 by 100 is nothing but 0.22 whole cube. And so on, the last one I am going to written as 11 into 9 by 100 whole cube. 11 into 9, 99, 99 by 100 is nothing but 0.99 whole cube. So in all these terms, amma, 11 by 100 whole cube is the common one. Na? 11 by 100 whole cube is the common one. Na? If I take common, remaining should be what? 1 cube plus, 2 cube plus, 3 cube plus, and so on, 9 cube. Na? This value already we know, na? 2025. 11 by 100. 11 cube is nothing but 1331 by, so 100 into what am I, this value is what? 2025. Therefore, simply I am going to written as 1.331 into 3 decimals here into 2.025. Here 3 decimals. Total 6 decimals na? 6 zeros, 6 decimals. So now here 1.3 into 2, 2.6. Approximately 2.6. So your answer is what? 2.695. So option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 50. Find the value of this expression. So here, LCM is what, amma? LCM is what? LCM is what? A minus B. B minus C. C minus A. Na? This is the LCM. Na? Therefore, numerator what happened, amma? A minus B whole cube plus B minus C whole cube plus C minus A whole cube. Na? If I take LCM, A minus B, B minus C, C minus A is the LCM. Here B minus C, C minus A is there. But A minus B is missing. A minus B into A minus B whole square. That is nothing but A minus B whole cube. Similarly, B minus C whole cube. Similarly, C minus A whole cube. So we know one rule here. X cube plus Y cube plus Z cube is equal to 3ABC. When X plus Y plus Z is equal to 0. We know this one now. From algebraic identities, yes or no? X cube plus Y cube plus Z cube is equal to, sorry, 3XYZ. X cube plus Y cube plus Z cube is equal to 3XYZ. Okay, na, ma? If X plus Y plus Z is equal to 0, we know this one. Na? So just apply here, ma. Here, X is what? A minus B. A minus B, B is what? Y is what? B minus C. Z is what? C minus A. A get cancelled, B, B get cancelled, C, C get cancelled. And X plus Y plus Z is equal to 0, na? If X plus Y plus Z is equal to 0, then this one is what, am I, is equal to X cube plus plus Y cube plus Z cube is equal to 3XYZ. Na? Therefore, this one is equal to what, am I, 3. Therefore, your answer is what, am I? Your answer is what, 3. So this one goes to this side, 3 into XYZ, 3XYZ. So your answer is what? Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 51. If x plus 1 by x is equal to minus 2, then find the value of x to the power of 2n plus 1 plus 1 by x to the power of 2n plus 1. So in the first equation, amma, here, x plus 1 by x is equal to minus 2. In order to satisfy this one, amma, put x is equal to minus 1. So put x is equal to minus 1. If you put x is equal to minus 1, it is satisfying minus 1 plus minus 1, minus 2. Na? So here, whether n is even integer or odd, whatever it may be. If you take n is equal to 1, 2 plus 1, 3, minus 1 whole to the power of 3, minus 1. If you take n is equal to 2, 2 into 2, 4 plus 1, 5, x to the power of 5, minus 1 whole to the power of 5, minus 1 only. So whatever it may be, whether n is even or odd, whatever it may be, this should be minus 1 plus 1 by minus 1. So therefore, your answer is what, amma? Minus 2 itself. Your answer is what, amma? Minus 2. So minus 2. Option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. So put x is equal to minus 1. Question number 52. If x by 2x square plus 5x plus 2 is equal to 1 by 6, then find the value of x plus 1 by x. Look at me, amma. If I ulta this equation, then what I get? If you ulta and cancel with x. So 2x square by x, that is nothing but 2x plus, so xx get cancelled, plus 5 plus 2 by x is equal to 6. If you ulta, just ulta and divide it with x. Okay, namma? Then if I take common 2, 2 into x plus 1 x, 2 into x plus 1 by x is equal to 6 minus 5. Therefore, x plus 1 by x is equal to what, amma? X plus 1 by x is equal to what? So 1 by 2. 1 by 2. So your answer is option B. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Just plus 5 comes to this side, minus 5, 6 minus 5, 1. So x plus 1 by x is equal to 1 by 2. So your answer is what am I? X plus 1 by x is equal to 1 by 2. Exactly. Option B is the right answer. Just ulta that equation, then we will get the answer. Question number 53. If x plus a, x plus y is equal to a and xy is equal to b square, then find the value of x cube minus x square y minus xy square plus y cube in terms of a and b. Look at me, Amma, here. In the equation, x cube, in this one, I am adding 3x square y plus 3xy square. Adding and subtracting 3x square y plus 3xy square. Then what happened, Amma? X cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. X cube plus y cube and adding this one plus, and I am subtracting, and I am subtracting minus. What happened, Amma? Minus x square y minus xy square. I am subtracting 3x square y minus 3xy square. So here I am subtracting, here I am adding. Okay. So here I am subtracting and here I am adding. If I cancel these two, then I will get the original equation. All of you clear, Andy? Now, so this is in the form of x plus y whole cube, na? X plus y whole cube, na? X plus y, x cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube, x plus y whole cube, na? X plus y, so x plus y is equal to what am I, a cube, na? So a cube minus, this is what am I, of 4x square, this together is what, if we add these together, am I, this is what, minus 4x square y minus 4xy square, yes or na? All of you clear, Andy? So in place of amma, if I take 4xy common, amma, 4xy common, if I take 4xy common, minus 4xy, if I take minus 4xy common, so what happened? If I take 4xy common, x I will get, na, here it is y, x plus y. X plus y is nothing but a, 4xy. Xy is nothing but what? B square. Therefore, your answer is what? A cube minus 4b square. A, that is nothing but 4ab square. So your answer is a cube minus 4ab square. A cube minus 4ab square. So option C is the right answer. So a cube minus 4ab square. Option C is the right answer. So simply here, ma, adding and subtracting 3x square y plus 3xy square. All of you clear, Andy? So this together is minus 4x square y minus 4xy square. In these two, I take on minus 4xy. Remaining should be x plus y. X plus y is nothing but a. Xy is nothing but b square. Just I substituted. Question number 54. If x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then find the value of x square into y plus z plus y square into z plus x plus z square into x plus y plus 3xyz is what? So here, x plus y plus z is equal to 0. Amma, here, in place of y plus z, I am going to substitute. So y plus z, in place of y plus z is equal to minus x. Yes or no? If you substitute minus x here, this is minus x cube, na? This is minus x cube, na? Similarly, this is minus y cube, na? Because in place of z plus x, just substitute minus y. Minus y cube. Here, in place of x plus y, just substitute minus z. So minus z cube plus 3xyz is equal to 0. 3xyz is equal to 0. Therefore, x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to minus 3xyz is equal to 0. Yes or na? All of you clear, amma? So here, we know one algebraic identity, amma. If x plus y plus z is equal to 0, if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then x square, x cube plus y cube plus 3, z cube minus 3xyz is equal to 0. So our answer is what? 0. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. If x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to 0. So in case of x plus y plus z is equal to 0. All of you clear, amma? Otherwise, sometimes x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. Whatever it may be. So your answer is what, amma? 0. So in place of y plus z, I substitute minus x. Similarly, here minus y, here similarly minus z. Question number 55. If x minus y is equal to x plus y by 7 is equal to xy by 4 is equal to I assume some k, then x minus y is equal to k. X plus y by 7 is equal to 7k, xy is equal to 4k. xy is equal to 4k. Yes, sir, na? X minus y is equal to k. Look at me, all of you. X minus y is equal to k. X plus y is equal to 7k. X plus y is equal to 7k. Therefore, 4x, x is equal to, here I assume, x is equal to 4k. Y is equal to 3k. Then it is satisfied, na? Yes or not? If I take x is equal to 4k, y is equal to 3k, x plus y is equal to 7k, x minus y is equal to k, satisfied, na? Just a substitute here, ma. So here, x is equal to 4k, y is equal to 3k, y is equal to 3k, is equal to 4k. So 4k, 4k get cancelled, 4k, 4k get cancelled, k is equal to 1 by 3, k is equal to 1 by 3. In place of k is equal to 1 by 3, they're asking numerical value of xy. They're asking numerical value of xy. So xy is nothing but 4k na. So 4 into k is nothing but 1 by 3. K is nothing but what amma? 1 by 3. So 4 into 1 by 3, 4 by 3. So your answer is what amma? 4 by 3. So option 4 by 3. Option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Question number 56. If a regular polygon has each of its angles equal to 3 by 5 times of its two right angles, then find the number of sides. Then find the number of sides. So regular polygon, each of its angles. So interior angle is equal to 3 by 5 times of two right angles. Two right angles is nothing but, so 180 degrees. Each right angle 90 degrees. Two right angles is nothing but 180 degrees. So 536 are 736 are 108. Okay, Namma? So 536, 5 how many times amma? 72 jars. So 5, 36 hours, 180, 3, 36 hours, 108. So interior angle is equal to 108. If interior angle is equal to 108, amma, exterior angle is equal to 72. We know very well, interior angle plus exterior angle will be equal to 180 degrees. Because that is a straight line. Okay, amma, interior angle plus exterior angle, sum must and should be 180. So if interior angle is 108, therefore exterior angle is 72. They're asking, so number of sides. We know very well, number of sides. So we know very well, exterior angle is equal to 360 degrees by n. 360 degrees by n. Exterior angle is equal to 360 degrees by n. Now I need n. So n is equal to 360 degrees by exterior angle. Exterior angle is what am I? 72. 72 how many times and 5 times. Therefore number of sides, that is a pentagon. So option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 57. The heights of a cone, cylinder and hemisphere are equal. If their radii are in the ratio 2 is to 3 is to 1, then find the ratio of their volumes. So cone volume. Cone volume is what am I? 1 by third pi r square h. 1 by third pi r square h is to. Next is cylinder. Cylinder volume is what am I? Pi r square h. Pi r square h. Next hemisphere. Hemisphere. Hemisphere is nothing but, sphere is nothing but 4 by third. Hemisphere is nothing but 2 by third. 2 by third pi r cube. 2 by third pi r cube. Okay, Namma? Sorry. The heights. So here, look at me, all of you. H1, H, in this r, r cube, r get cancelled. Therefore, remaining should be what am I? R square. Now, they're asking, they're given radii in the ratio 2 is to 3 is to 1. So cancel pi, pi, pi. So next amma. In place of first one, r is what amma? 2 na? 2 square is nothing but 4 na? And 4 by 3. Here it is what amma? Simply r square. R square is nothing but 9. Here simply 1 only. So r square 1, 2 by 3 only. So LCM is 3. Cancel with 3. 4 is 2. So 27 is to 2. Your answer is what amma? 4 is to 27 is to 2. 4 is to 27 is to 2. Option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Question number 58. Base of a right pyramid is a square. Length of diagonal of the base is 24 root 2. If the volume of the pyramid is 1728 cubic meters, then its slant height is how much? Volume of the pyramid. So volume of the pyramid is nothing but, so area of the base into height. Area of the base into height. So base is look like a square. Base is look like a square. They give square diagonal. Square diagonal is 24 root 2. First of all, what is the square diagonal, amma? Root 2a. So root 2a is equal to 24 root 2. Root 2 root 2 get cancelled. Then a is equal to 24. A is equal to what, amma? 24. So side is equal to 24. Side. So the base of the pyramid is what amma? So square, that square side is 24. So what is the volume of the pyramid? Volume of the pyramid is 1 by third into area of the base. Area of the base is nothing but, so here 24 into 24. Area of the base is nothing but what amma? 24 into 24 into height. So I need to find out height. is equal to 1728 is equal to what amma 1728 so 24 into 24 576 na 576 ones are 576 threes are therefore h is equal to 9 but they are not asking height they ask height height is what amma 9 but they are not asking height chaala mandi height anukoni 9 ana option click chesaru height veru slant height veru height is different slant height is different okay nandi so generally prism height is there but in pyramid slant height is there ala clear andi look similarly so cylinder and cone in cone slant height is there in pyramid also slant height is there so look at me amma how to find out slant height say for example this is a square base amma square base andi this is what on the square side it is what total it is 24 it is 12 na height is what 9 na height is what 9 na they are asking what andi they are asking slant height 12 9 is there so 12 9 so which one is the Pythagoras triplet code amma 9 12 15 9 12 15 is the Pythagoras triplet code so 9 square 9 is the height 12 is the base so total it is 24 total it is 24 okay namma it is 12 half 12 12 plus 9 12 square plus 9 square 144 plus 81 225 so slant height is equal to 15 slant height is equal to what amma 15 so option d is the right answer option d is the right answer question number 59 the height of a right circular cone and the radius of its circular base are respectively 9 cm and 3 cm the cone cut by a plane parallel to its base so as to divide it into two parts the volume of the first one of the cone it is 44 cubic meters so the radius of the upper circular surface area of the first one they are asking the radius of the upper circular surface of the first one so here if I draw one cone amma This is capital R, this is small h and the entire thing should be capital H so they given this one is what 3 and the height they given right circular cone height they given sorry height is equal to what amma 9 height is equal to what 9 the cone cut by a parallel plane to its first of all find out the volume of the cone is equal to what amma volume of the cone is equal to what 1 by third pi r square h pi into r square is nothing but 3 square 9 h is nothing but also 9 h is nothing but 9 that is nothing but what amma 3 3 jars 3 9 jars 27 pi the volume of the cone is 27 pi so the bottom part of they given so the volume of the first term that is nothing but bottom part will be equivalent to what amma 44 so volume of bottom of the cone is equal to 144 is equal to sorry 44 that will be equivalent to 14 pi that will be equivalent to if you calculate that will be equivalent to 14 pi if you calculate that is the first term of a cone then you will get 14 pi then upper part is what volume of upper part is what total is 27 pi bottom part is 14 pi upper part is 13 pi na upper part is nothing but one third pi r square h na pi r square h na is equal to 13 pi is equal to 13 pi so pi pi get cancel 3 comes to that side 39 r square h is equal to 39 r square h is equal to 39 r square h is equal to 39 now I need to find out r value so I need to convert h value in terms of r so in order to convert h value in terms of r amma so we know that these two are similar triangles simply I go for h by 9 is equal to small r by 3 so 3 ones are 3 threes are h is equal to 3r h is equal to 3r small h will be equivalent to 3r so by using similar triangles because this triangle and the entire triangle those two are similar triangles okay nandi h is equal to 3r in place of h if you substitute 3r then total it is what amma 3r cube na 3r cube is equal to what amma 39 So R cube is equal to 13. R cube is equal to what? 313 jars. So R is equal to what? Cube root 13. R is equal to what? Cube root 13. Therefore, radius of the, so the upper part, it is what? Cube root 13. Cube root 13. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 60. A cylinder and a cone have equal radius. Cylinder and cone have equal radius of their bases and equal heights. If their curved surface areas are in the ratio 8:5, the ratio of their radius to height, it is what? Curved surface area of a cylinder. Curved surface area of a cylinder is what? 2 pi r h. 2 pi r h. And curved surface area of the cone. So pi r l. What am I? Pi r l. That will be equivalent to 8:5. 8 by 5. 8 by 5. Now if I cancel and pi pi get cancel. Okay, nama r r get cancel. 2 1s are, 2 4s are. So h by l is equal to, h by l is equal to 4 by 5. In place of L, I am going to substitute. Okay, Randy, I am going to substitute R. If I go for squaring on both sides, H square by L square is equal to 16 by 25. Now, just squaring on both sides, we know L square is nothing but R square plus H square. R square plus H square. Okay, Rama. So we know very well this is L, this is H, this is R. So L square is nothing but what? H square plus R square. So h square by h square plus r square is equal to 16 by 25. Yes or no? If you volta this equation, then h square plus r square by h square is equal to 25 by 16. 25 by 16. Okay, namma. Now I need what? R2H kada? R2H kada? Simply I'm here. H square get cancelled. R square by H square is equal to plus 1 na. Plus 1 comes to this side. 25 by 16 minus 1. Therefore, R square by H square is equal to 9 by 16. R by H is equal to 3 by 4. 3 by 4. So they're asking radius to height. 3:4. Option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Question number 61. A solid is a hemispherical at the bottom and conical above. If the surface area of the two parts are equal, then the ratio of the radius and heights of conical part is how much? Ratio of radius to height. Ratio of radius to height. Question is this one. And they given what am I? So if the surface area of the two parts are equal and the conical hemispherical part as well as conical above. Hemispherical. So hemispherical is nothing but 2 pi r square. 2 pi r square is equal to conical. Conical is nothing but pi r l. Pi r l. These two are equal. Pi pi get cancelled. R get cancelled. So L is equal to R. L is equal to what? 2 R. L is equal to R. And we know the relation. L is nothing but what am I? L is nothing but. So L is nothing but square root of H square plus R square. H square plus R square. In place of L, substitute 2R, amma. So 2R is equal to square root of H square plus R square. H square plus R square. Squaring on both sides, then 4R square is equal to H square plus R square. R square, R square get cancelled. 3R square is equal to H square. R square is equal to H square. They're asking radius to height. R square by H square is equal to R square by H square is equal to, this is 3R square now. It comes to this side, 1 by 3. So R by H is equal to 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3. So your answer is what? 1:√3. 1:√3. Option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Question number 62. Base of a right prism is an equilateral triangle of side 6 centimeters. If the volume of the prism is 108√3 cubic meters, then find its height. So volume of the prism is equal to area of the base into height. Area of the base into area of base into height. They're asking height. They're asking what am I? Height. So volume is how much am I? 108√3. 108√3. So area of the base, it's look like a equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle area is what am I? Root 3 by 4 a square. Here a is what they given? 6. 6 into 6 into height. So now I need to find out height. Look at me, am I? Root 3 get cancelled. 36 ones are, 36 threes are. Therefore, height is equal to 12. Height of the prism is equal to 12. So height of the prism is equal to what? 12. Option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Question number 63. ABC are three points in a circle. The tangent A meets BC produced at T. Angle BTA is equal to 40 degrees. Angle CAT is equal to 44 degrees. The angle subtended by BC at the center of the circle is how much? So here, if it is a circle, tangent A, if I produced BC at T, BC is produced up to T, tangent A. They are asking the angle subtended to the center. This is O. They given BTA is 40. BTA is 40. And they given CAT is 44. CAT is 44. If this is 44, this angle is also 44. This is 44, this is 40. Together is 84. Remaining should be 96. The remaining total it is what? Remaining total it is what? So 40, 84. 84 is nothing but this is 42, this is 42. This is 42. 42, 44, 86. The remaining should be 104. They're asking the angle subtended at the center. So option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Question number 64. If the length of a chord of a circle at a distance of 12 centimeters from the center is 10 centimeters, then the diameter of the circle is how much? A circle, it is a center, center to chord distance is what about 12? Chord length is 10. If chord length is 10, these two are equal. This is 5 and this is 5. Okay, they are asking the radius. First of all, you have to find out radius. So this is perpendicular bisector. Okay, this is 90 degrees. 5 or 12, which one is missing? 13 is missing. If radius is 13, they are asking diameter. Diameter is 26. Option C is the right answer. So center to chord distance is 12. Chord length is 10. If chord length is 10, this part is 5. 5 to 12, this part is 13. Therefore, radius is 13. Diameter is 26. So option C is the right answer. Question number 65. If tan theta is equal to sin alpha minus cos alpha by sin alpha plus cos alpha, then sin alpha plus cos alpha is equal to how much? Look at me, Amma. This one I am going to written as 1 plus tan square theta. 1 plus tan square theta. If I am going to written 1 plus tan square theta, this is also 1 plus this one whole square. So that is nothing but 1 plus is nothing but sine alpha plus cos alpha whole square plus sine alpha minus cos alpha whole square divided by sin alpha cos alpha whole square. So 1 plus this one, just 1 plus tan square theta, and here also 1 plus this one. So LCM is sin alpha cos alpha whole square, sin alpha cos alpha whole square plus this one. Okay, namma. Now this value is 1 na? This value is 1 na? Sin alpha cos alpha, not 1. If I expand this one, just wait, amma. This is a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, na? A plus b whole square. Here plus 2 sin alpha cos alpha. Here minus 2 sin alpha cos alpha get cancelled. Then what happened, amma? So this from this one, what happened? From this one, what happened, andi? So I will get 2 times of sin square alpha cos square alpha. 2 times of sin square alpha cos square alpha. Yes or not? So sin square alpha plus cos square alpha, this part is what? 1. Therefore, entire numerator is 2. Entire numerator is what? 2. So 1 plus tan square alpha. 1 plus tan square alpha is nothing but secant square alpha is equal to 2 by sin alpha cos alpha whole square. Whole square. This one I am going to written as 1 by cos square theta. 1 by cos square theta is equal to 1 by cos square alpha is equal to, so 2 by sin alpha cos alpha whole square. Now I need in terms of sin alpha cos alpha. So sin alpha cos alpha whole square is equal to sin alpha cos alpha whole square is equal to what happened, amma? 2 into cos square alpha. 2 into cos square alpha. I need sin alpha cos alpha. I need sin alpha cos alpha. Sin alpha cos alpha is equal to sin alpha plus cos alpha is equal to plus or minus root 2 cos alpha. Plus or minus root 2 cos alpha. So your answer is plus or minus root 2 cos alpha. So root 2 cos alpha. cos theta kada, sorry, cos theta root 2 cos theta. So option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. If O is the circumference of triangle ABC and OBC, angle OBC is equal to 35 degrees, then the angle BAC is equivalent to how much? O is the circumcenter of the triangle ABC. O is the circumcenter of the triangle ABC. Then angle OBC is 35 degrees. If this is 35 degrees, look at me, all of you. This is radius, OB is radius, OC also radius. This is also 35 degrees, na? Yes or not? 35, 70. If this is 70, this angle is what? 110. Because OBC is a triangle. 35, 35, 70 plus 110, 180. So angle subtended to the center is always twice to this one. Therefore, angle BAC is 55 degrees. Angle BAC is what? 55 degrees. Option A is the right answer. They're asking angle BAC. BAC. Angle subtended to the center is always twice to the this one. Is always twice to the remaining part of the circumference of 80 any point of the circle. Okay, Nama? So your answer is 55 degrees. Option A is the right answer. Question number 67. If I is the in center of a triangle ABC, angle BAC is equal to 135 degrees. Then find, so ABC is a which type of triangle? Look at me, Amma. Angle BIC is nothing but 90 degrees plus half of angle A. So BAC is equal to what, Amma? 135 degrees. BAC is equal to what? 135 degrees. If 90 comes this side, so half of angle A is equal to 45 degrees, therefore angle A is equal to 90 degrees. So one of the angle is 90 degrees, then that type of triangle is what? Right angle triangle. So option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Question number 68. A rectangular tank is 45 meters long and 26 meters broad. So water flows through a pipe whose cross section area is 13 square centimeters at the rate of 9 km per hour. How much will be the level of the water rise in the tank in 15 minutes? So first of all, tank. So 45 meters, na? So 45 meters is nothing but 4500 centimeters. 2600 into how much water level rises. So here cross sectional area is 13. Into speed is what, am I? 9 km per hour. So 9000 centimeters na into 100. So 15 minutes na, and 1/4 of the hour. 1/4 of the hour. So 15 minutes is nothing but 1/4 of the hour. So 1 hour it is that one na. So 15 minutes is nothing but 1/4. Now I need to find out what, am I? H value. How much level water rises. So if you observe carefully here, Andy, 4 ones are 4 250 times, 2500. So 9 ones are 9 fives are. So 1300 ones are 1300 and twos are. 5 ones are 550s are. 2 ones are 225 are. Okay, Namma. In game, Namma, what happened? So here 2 zeros are there, na? 25 ones are, 25 fours are. 25 ones are, 25 fours are. So h is equal to 1/4, and 0.25 meters. H is equal to 0.25 meters. H is equal to 0.25 meters, they are given in terms of 0.25 centimeters. We got 0.25 centimeters. Now we got 0.25 centimeters. They're asking in terms of meters. So H is equal to 0.0025 centimeters. So 0.0025 meters. Option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. L into B into H is equal to how much water is coming, how much water level rises. Okay, Namma. Question number 69. Find the values of A and B so that x to the power of 4 plus x cube plus 6a plus 8x square plus ax plus b is perfectly divisible by x square plus 1. X to the power of 4 plus x cube plus 8x square plus ax plus b. So if I divide with x square plus 1. If I multiply with x square, amma, x to the power of 4 plus x square. If I cancel and if I cancel with minus, this one get cancelled. X cube minus x square. If I take 8x square, that is plus 7x square. Now I multiply with x. And x cube plus x. X cube get cancelled. This is 7x square minus x. Minus x plus 8x plus ax. Now I multiply with 7 plus 7. Then I will get 7x square plus 7. If I cancel, minus 7 minus x plus ax plus b. So no need to solve and so finally we got this one. If you put a is equal to 1, put a is equal to 1, plus x minus x get cancelled. Put b is equal to plus 7. Plus 7 plus 7 get cancelled. Therefore, remainder is 0. Therefore, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 7. Option a is the right answer. Question number 70. If the equation 1 plus m square into x square plus 2 mcx plus c square minus a square is equal to 0 has equal roots. This is very, very important. Am I has equal roots. Whenever they give equal roots, there is nothing but b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. B square minus 4ac is equal to 0 and b square is equal to 4ac. B square is equal to 4ac. B square is nothing but what, amma? So 4 m square. This is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Okay. So b is nothing but 2mc. B is nothing but 2mc. So 4 m square c square is equal to b square is equal to 4ac. 4 into a is what, amma? 1 plus m square. 1 plus m square. C is what, amma? C square A square. C square minus A square. Now. So 4, 4 get cancelled. This is what? 1 into C square minus A square. M square C square. M square A square. Now M square C square. M square C square. M square C square get cancelled. So in these two, if you take common, minus a square, that one comes to this side, minus m square a square is equal to c square minus a square. So a square neutral pampichanamma, then if I take m square take common, they're asking what? Find the value of a square into 1 plus m square. If I take a square common, this a square comes to this side, if I take a square get common, 1 plus m square is equal to c square. Therefore, your answer is what, am I, is equal to c square. Option C is the right answer. Remember, and all of you, whenever they give equal roots, there is b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. B square is equal to 4ac. Okay, namma? So this is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Just equate. Then you will get. So a square into 1 plus m square is equal to c square. Option C is the right answer. Number 71. So two circles of radius 5 cm and 3 cm intersect at two points and the distance between their centers is 4. Find the length of the common chord. So two circles, the distance between the centers is 4. They're asking length of the common chord. Length of the common chord divides the given into the distance between the centers. This line divides the common chord into two equal parts. One radius is 5, another radius is 3. So the distance between the two centers, this is O, this is O dash. Distance between the two centers is 4. Say for example, this part I assume as x. This part must and should be 4 minus x because total is 4. These two are right angles. Okay, namma. Now I am going to apply. This is the common one. So 5 square minus x square is equal to 3 square minus 4 minus x whole square. So 5 square 25 minus x square, 3 square 9 minus, so 4 square is nothing but 16 minus 16, so minus x square plus 8x, x square get cancelled, this is plus 8x, this is minus 7, plus 7 it comes to this side, 8x is equal to 32, x is equal to 4, if x is equal to 4, this part is 4, this part is 4, this part is 4, this part is 5 na. If this is 5, this is 4, this must and should be 3. 5, 4, 3 is a Pythagoras triplet code. If this is 3, this part is also 3. Therefore, length of the common chord is 6. Length of the common chord is 6. So, option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. 72. Question number 72. A boat is moving away from an observation tower. It makes an angle of depression of 60 degrees with an observer's eye. When at a distance of 50 meters from the tower, after 8 seconds, the angle of depression becomes 30 degrees by assuming that it is running in still water. The approximate speed of the boat is how much? This is the tower. The initial how much distance is there from 50 meters? The angle of depression is 60 degrees. After 8 seconds, somewhere it is run. And now angle of depression is 30 degrees. So tan 60 root 3 by 1 na. This is root 3 part. This 50 is nothing but one part. This 50 is what? One part. So whenever angle become twice, this distance will be equivalent to two parts. This distance will be equivalent to two parts. If this is one part, this is two parts. One part is 50, then two parts is 100. Remember, Andy, whenever the theta become twice, this is one part, this is two parts. Okay, Andy? So distance covered in 8 seconds is 100 meters. Distance is 100 meters, time is 8 seconds. Speed is nothing but distance by time into, so I need in terms of kilometer per hour, 18 by 5. So 520 is hours. So 4 5s are, 4 2s are, 2 9s are, 9 5s are, 45. Answer is 45 kilometer per hour. Option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Question number 73. Two circles with the centers A and B of radii 3 centimeters and 4 centimeters respectively intersected two points C and D such that AC and BC are tangents to the two circles. Find the length of the common chord. CD. Look at me, all of you. This is this is one circle and this is another circle. These are the centers. One it is 3, another one it is 4. So this is 3, 4, 5. It's a right angle triangle because these two are tangents. They're asking common chord. They're asking common chord. Common chord. So these two are equal. These two parts are equal. These are right angles. If I assume this is x, this is 5 minus x. Okay. Now, what happened, Amma? 3 square minus 5 minus x whole square is equal to 4 square minus x square. 4 square minus x square. 9 minus 25 plus x minus x square minus plus 10x is equal to 16 minus x square. X square, x square get cancelled. This is 25 minus 25, that is nothing but minus 16 plus 32. 10x is equal to 32, x is equal to 3.2. X is equal to 3.2. X is 3.2. Now I need this part. Now I need this part. So this part is 3.2, this part is 4. So say for example, this is, they're asking common chord CD. This is D, C, this is D, and this is O. CO square is equal to, CO is equal to square root of 4 square, 16 minus 3.2 square is nothing but, so 32 square, 1024, 10.24. Remaining it is 5.76. 5.76 is nothing but 2.4. CY is equal to 2.4. If CY is 2.4, so OD also 2.4. 2.4, 2.4, 4.8. Therefore, option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. CO, this part is 2.4. This part is also 2.4. Total common chord it is 4.8. Option D is the right answer. Question number 74. Given that cube root of 3 power x is equal to 5 to the power of 1 by 4 and 4th root of 5 to the power of 5 is equal to root 3, then find the value of 2xy. So this one I am going to written as 3x whole power 1 by 3 na, therefore 3 power x by 3 is equal to 5 to the power of 1 by 4. So 5y whole to the power of 1 by 4, then 5 to the power of y by 4 is equal to 3 power 1 by 2. This y comes to this side. 5 to the power of 1 by 4 is equal to 3 to the power of 1 by 2y. Here, these two are equal, na? Therefore, I am going to equate other sides. 3 to the power of x by 3 is equal to 3 to the power of 1 by 2y. Bases are equal, na? Then therefore I am going to equate powers. X by 3 is equal to 1 by 2y. 2xy is equal to 3. Cross multiply 2xy is equal to 3. They are asking 2xy. 2xy is equal to what? 3. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 75. The base of a rectangular solid is a square. If its height is twice of its length. If its volume is 16,000 cubic meters, find the total surface area. So height is twice of its length. X అనుకుంటే హైట్ ఏమవుతుందమ్మా 2x అవుతుంది ఎస్ ఆర్ నాట్ ద బేస్ ఆఫ్ ఎ రెక్టాంగులర్ సాలిడ్ ఇస్ ఎ స్క్వేర్ సో 2x స్క్వేర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 16,000 ఓకేనమ్మా 2 1 జార్స్ 2 8 8 జార్ 80,000 సో బేస్ అంటే బేస్ ఇంకోటి ఎక్స్ క్యూబ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 8 ఎక్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ 20 సో సాలిడ్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఎల్ ఇంటూ బి ఇంటూ హెచ్ ఎల్ ఇంటూ బి ఇంటూ హెచ్ ఎల్ బి బోత్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ ఎల్ బి బోత్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ సో హైట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ 2 టైమ్స్ ఆఫ్ దట్ వన్ ఓకేనమ్మా ఎక్స్ క్యూబ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 8,000 ఎక్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ 20 దేర్ ఆస్కింగ్ సో ఫైండ్ ద టోటల్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏరియా అంటే ఏంటమ్మా 2 ఇంటూ ఎల్బి ప్లస్ బిహెచ్ ప్లస్ హెచ్ఎల్ ఎల్బి ప్లస్ బిహెచ్ ప్లస్ హెచ్ఎల్ ఇప్పుడు ఎక్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ 20 L is equal 20, B is equal 20, H is equal twice na, H is equal 40. Okay na ma? Therefore, 2 times of LB 400, BH 800, HL 800. So 1600, 2000, 2000, 2000 is 4000. Therefore, total surface area is 4000. Total surface area is 4000. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 76. The volume of a cylinder ring is cylindrical ring is 800 cubic centimeters and the radius of the cross section is 12 centimeters. Find the surface area of the ring. So volume is nothing but pi r square h. So 22 by 7 into 12 into 12 into h is equal to 800. H is equal to 5600 by so 22 into 144. So if I multiply, if you cancel this one, then you will get 1.76. H is 1.76. Now I need surface area. Surface area is nothing but 2 pi r h. 2 into 22 by 7 into r is 12, h is 1.76. So if you cancel this one, then you will get 133.3. Therefore, surface area is 133.3. So option D is the right answer. So in ABC, the bisector of angle B meets AC at D and a line PQ is parallel to AC meets AB and BC. BD at P, Q, R respectively. Then AB, then ABCQ, then ABCQ. Together, maybe ABCQ is what? In a triangle ABC. A line PQ. ABC, the angle bisector of B meets AC. At D. A line PQ is parallel to AC. PQ is parallel to AC. Meets AB, BC, BD. So AB at P, next to BC at Q, and BD at R. This is R. Okay, then ABCQ. This is by Thales theorem. Amma. So here AB by AP is equal to CB by CQ. So I need AB into CQ is equal to CB into AP. So your answer is CB into AP. Option A. So by using Thales theorem, AB by AP is equal to CB by CQ. Okay, namma? Now I need AB into CQ is equal to CB into AP. Option A is the right answer. Question number 78. A metal sphere 14 centimeters in diameter. So 14 centimeters in diameter is nothing but radius is 7. Is a dropped into a rectangular cistern whose base measures 49 and 44 by 3. If the sphere is totally submerged, by how much will surface area of the water be raised? So 49 into 44 by 3 into h. How much height rises? So what we are putting amma is PO. Is PO. Speed is nothing but what? 4 by 3 pi r cube. So 4 by 3 pi r cube. 22 by 7 into pi r cube. So r is what amma? 7. R is what amma? 7. 7 into 7 into 7. 7, 7 get cancelled. Okay, number 3, 3 get cancelled. Now I need to find out h value. So 44 ones are, 44 twos are. 49, 49 get cancelled. H is equal to, h is equal to what amount? 2. So how much height increases amma? 2 centimeters. So option A is the right answer. So question number 79. The perimeter of one square exceeds that of another by 100 meters. So area of the largest square exceeds 3 times that of smaller one by 325 square meters. The length of the side of the smaller square is how much? They're asking the length of the side of a smaller square. I go through options and if smaller square I assume as, if smaller square I assume as 30, largest square automatically what am I? So largest square. So smaller square I assume as 30. So here side is 30, perimeter is what? 120. Perimeter is what? 120. Here the perimeter of a square exceeds that another by 100 meters. Therefore another 180 is what? 220. Larger 180 is 220. Larger one perimeter is 220, side is 35. Side is 55. Larger one it is 220, side is what am I? 55. Because so this the difference is 100. The difference is 100. Okay namma? So area is what amma? Area is what? A square is nothing but 900. 30 square is nothing but 900. So 55 square is nothing but 3025. 55 square is nothing but 3025. So here they given one more statement. Area of the largest square. The area of the largest square is nothing but 3025. Exceeds 3 times that of smaller square. 3 times of that of smaller square. 3 times of that of smaller square is nothing but 2700 by 325 by 325 3225 minus 2700 325 na and it is satisfied na. So it is satisfied, then your answer is what? 30. All of you clear and option A is the right answer. I go through options and so meer x anukoni ledante it will take some time to calculate that one. Okavela 30 na answer kaakapaina vachetuvanti answer ni base chesukoni nen option pick cheyagalanu ante vachetuvanti ipo naaku ikkada vachetuvanti difference ni base chesukoni nen ee option pick cheyalo kuda decide cheyagalanu. Okay namma? A right pyramid stands on a rectangular base 32 cm long and 10 cm in width. If the height of the pyramid is 12, so find its whole surface area, total surface area. So total surface area is nothing but amma, total surface area is nothing but lateral surface area plus area of the base. So here area of the base is nothing but, we know very well, base is look like a rectangular field. That is nothing but area of the base is 32 into 10. That is nothing but 320. Area of the base we know very well, but I need to find out lateral surface area. Before find out lateral surface area, I need slant heights. First of all, draw the diagram, Amma, then we will get the idea regarding this one. Bases look like a rectangle. So one side is 32, another side is 10. Okay. So the height of the, this one is 12, this is 12. So three dimensional ఉంటుందండి మనం చూపించడం కష్టము. Three dimensions కూడా, two dimensional board మీద. Okay నండి, అది. First of all, L1, slant height L1 is equal to, slant height L1 is equal to, so one slant height, I know this is half. Half అంటే 5 కదా, 5 plus 12. 5 square plus 12 square is nothing but, 5 square plus 12 square is nothing but 13. L2, slant height L2. So another one is what am I, 16 na? Another one it is what am I, 16 na? Dintlo half chusukovali. Another side is 32 is nothing but 16. 16 square plus 12 square. 16 square ante 256 plus 144. 400, 420. L1 is 13, L2 is 20. Now I need to find out, so lateral surface area. Lateral surface area amma. So lateral surface area find out cheyal chudanamma. Lateral surface area. Lateral surface find out cheyalandi. So lateral surface la chuste first ga manamu area of the triangle on side AB and CD. AB and CD. Okay. And first of all, this A and B and D. దీన్ని అనుకుందాం. ఓకేనమ్మా? సో లేటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ మనం చూసినట్లయితే టూ ఉంటాయి, మనకు కనిపించేది ఒక సైడ్ ఉంటుంది, కనిపించేది ఇంకొక పార్ట్ ఉంటుంది. సో టూ టైమ్స్ ఆఫ్ హాఫ్ ఇంటూ బేస్ ఇంటూ హైట్, హాఫ్ ఇంటూ బేస్ ఇంటూ హైట్. సో బేస్ ఇస్ వన్ బేస్ ఇస్ వాటమ్మా 32. సో బేస్ ఇస్ 32, స్లాండ్ హైట్ ఎంతమ్మా? స్లాండ్ హైట్ ఎంతమ్మా? 13. దిస్ ఈస్ వన్ వ్యూ. సో అనదర్ వ్యూ ఇస్ వాట్? సో ప్లస్ టూ టైమ్స్ ఆఫ్ హాఫ్ ఇంటూ బేస్ ఇస్ వాట్? నెక్స్ట్ టైం బేస్ ఇస్ 10, బేస్ ఇస్ వన్, బేస్ ఇస్ 10. సో 10 ఇంటూ అనదర్ స్లాండ్ హైట్ ఇస్ వాటమ్మా? 20. అనదర్ స్లాండ్ హైట్ ఇస్ 20. దిస్ ఇస్ లేటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏరియా. దిస్ ఇస్ వాటమ్మా? లేటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏరియా. నౌ క్యాన్సల్ ని టూ టూ గెట్ క్యాన్సల్, టూ టూ గెట్ క్యాన్సల్. సో 32 జార్స్. 32 జార్స్ ఇస్ హౌ మచ్ అమ్మా? 32 జార్, దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ 30 జార్స్ 390. 32 జార్స్ 26. 390 ప్లస్ 26 216. సో 26 ప్లస్ 390 416. 416 ప్లస్ 200 టోటల్ ఇస్ వాటమ్మా? 616. టోటల్ వాటమ్మా? 616. సో లేటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏరియా 616. లేటరల్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏరియా ఇస్ వాట్? 616. ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ద బేస్ ఇస్ 320. టోటల్ 936. టోటల్ 936. దేర్ఫోర్ యువర్ ఆన్సర్ ఇస్ వాట్? ఆప్షన్ బి. ఆప్షన్ బి ఇస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్. ఆప్షన్ బి ఇస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్. క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 81. ఫర్ వాట్ వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఫైండ్ దట్ ఏ పవర్ ఎన్ ప్లస్ వన్ ప్లస్ బి పవర్ ఎన్ ప్లస్ వన్ బై ఏ పవర్ ఎన్ బై టూ ప్లస్ బి పవర్ ఎన్ బై టూ ఈస్ ద అర్థమాటిక్ మీన్ ఆఫ్ ఏ అండ్ బి? అర్థమాటిక్ మీన్ ఆఫ్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఏ ప్లస్ బి, ఏ ప్లస్ బి బై టూ, ఏ ప్లస్ బి బై టూ. సో ఇఫ్ యూ పుట్ ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ జీరో, ఇఫ్ యూ పుట్ ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ జీరో, ఇఫ్ యూ పుట్ ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ జీరో, వాట్ హ్యాపెన్ అమ్మా? ఏ ప్లస్ బి బై ఏ పవర్ జీరో ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ వన్, బి పవర్ జీరో ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ వన్. ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ సెట్ నా. సో పుట్ ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ జీరో, పుట్ ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. సో ఆప్షన్ సి ఈజ్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్. సో ద క్వాడ్రిలేటరల్ హూస్ వర్టిసెస్ ఆర్ మైనస్ వన్ వన్, జీరో కామా మైనస్ త్రీ, ఫైవ్ కామా టూ అండ్ ఫోర్ కామా సిక్స్. ఇఫ్ యూ డ్రా దీస్ పాయింట్స్ ఆన్ కార్టీషియన్ కోఆర్డినేట్స్, ఇఫ్ యూ డ్రా దిస్ వన్, సో మైనస్ వన్ ప్లస్ వన్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ మైనస్ వన్. సో సమ్వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మైనస్ వన్ ప్లస్ వన్, సమ్వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మైనస్ వన్ ప్లస్ వన్. ఎస్ ఆర్ నాట్? ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ ప్లస్, ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ మైనస్, వై యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ వన్ అండ్ జీరో కామా మైనస్ త్రీ, జీరో కామా మైనస్ త్రీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ సమ్వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ జీరో, ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ జీరో అండ్ వై యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ మైనస్ త్రీ. సో వై యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ మైనస్ త్రీ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ సమ్వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ హియర్. సో ఫైవ్ కామా టూ, సో ఫైవ్ కామా టూ, ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఫైవ్, వై యాక్సిస్ టూ, వై యాక్సిస్ టూ, సమ్వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్, సమ్వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్. సో ఫోర్ కామా సిక్స్, ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ఇస్ ఫోర్, వై యాక్సిస్ సిక్స్, సమ్వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్. అండ్ ఇఫ్ యూ ప్లేన్ దిస్ వన్, ఇఫ్ యూ జాయిన్ దిస్ వన్, సో దీస్ టూ ఆర్ ఇట్స్ నాట్ ఎ రెక్టాంగిల్ బికాస్ సైడ్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఈక్వల్. ఓకేనమ్మా? సో ఇట్స్ దీస్ యాంగిల్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఈక్వల్, సో ఇట్స్ మే బి పారలాగ్రామ్. ఓకేనమ్మా? ఇఫ్ యూ ప్లేస్ దీస్ పాయింట్స్ అనే కార్టీషియన్ కోఆర్డినేట్ సిస్టమ్ దెన్ విల్ గెట్ ద ఎగ్జాక్ట్ ఫిగర్ వాట్ వాట్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ఫార్మ్ బై యూజింగ్ దీస్ ఫోర్ పాయింట్స్. సో ఆప్షన్ డి ఇస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్. ఆప్షన్ డి ఇస్ ద ఆన్సర్. సో మీరు స్క్వైర్ అయితే కాదు, రాంబైస్ అయితే కాదు, సో మరి రెక్టాంగిల్ అవుతుందా పారలాగ్రామ్ అవుతుందా? సో రెక్టాంగిల్ పారలాగ్రామ్ ఏంటంటే రెండు పారలాగ్రామ్ రెక్టాంగిల్ కూడా ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్స్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ అండ్ ప్యారలల్. బట్ ఇక్కడ ఇక్కడ ఏం మీరు చూస్తే యాంగిల్స్ అనేవి 90 డిగ్రీస్ అనేవి ఎగ్జాక్ట్గా ఉండవు ఇక్కడ. ఓకేనమ్మా? అది మీరు కావాలంటే డ్రా నీట్గా డ్రా చేస్తే, మీరు ఎగ్జాక్ట్ తీసుకొని డ్రా చేస్తే చెప్పగలుగుతాం. ఓకేనండి? క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 83. ఇఫ్ జి ఇస్ ద సెంట్రాయిడ్ అండ్ ఏడి బిఈ సిఎఫ్ ఆర్ ద త్రీ మీడియన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏబీసీ విత్ ఏరియా 144 స్క్వేర్ సెంటీమీటర్ దెన్ ఫైండ్ ద ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ట్రయాంగిల్ బిడిసి. సో ఏబీసీ ఈజ్ ఏబీసీ ఈజ్ ఏ ట్రయాంగిల్, జి ఇస్ ద సెంట్రాయిడ్, జి ఇస్ ద సెంట్రాయిడ్, జి ఇస్ ద సెంట్రాయిడ్. సో ది గివెన్ ఏడి, సో ఏడి బిఈ, ఏడి బిఈ సిఎఫ్, ఓకే, త్రీ మీడియన్స్ విత్ ఏరియా 144 స్క్వేర్ సెంటీమీటర్స్ దెన్ ద ఏరియా ఆఫ్ బిడిజి, 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 దిస్ పార్ట్ అండ్ దిస్ పార్ట్ అండ్ దిస్ పార్ట్ అండ్ దిస్ పార్ట్ ఆల్ ఏరియాస్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్. టోటల్ హౌ మెనీ పార్ట్స్ అండి? సిక్స్ పార్ట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. సిక్స్ పార్ట్స్ ఇన్ నథింగ్ బట్ 144. సిక్స్ పార్ట్స్ ఇన్ నథింగ్ బట్ 144. నవ్ ఐ నీడ్ ఓన్లీ వన్ పార్ట్. సో వన్ పార్ట్ ఈస్ 24. సో యువర్ ఆన్సర్ ఇస్ వాట్? ఆప్షన్ సి. ఆప్షన్ సి ఈస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్. ఆప్షన్ సి ఈస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్. క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 84. ఏబీస్ ఆర్ ద సైడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎ రైట్ యాంగిల్ ట్రయాంగిల్ వేర్ సి ఇస్ ద హైపోటనస్, వేర్ సి ఇస్ ద హైపోటనస్, సో అండ్ ఆర్ ఇస్ ద రేడియస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇన్ సర్కిల్ విచ్ టచెస్ ద సైడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ట్రయాంగిల్ So then the radius r in terms of abc, then in terms of radius abc they're asking this r. Hypotenuse is c. So for example, this is abc, this is small b, this is small a. So for example, this is the standard formula, ma, r is equal to a plus b minus c by 2. This is standard formula, so direct formula. So r is equal to a plus b minus c by 2. So option a is the right answer. Option a is the right answer. Question number 85. If x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then find the value of this expression. This one, x plus y is equal to minus z, na? Minus z, na? Yes or not? Therefore, this one, if I go through squaring on both sides, x square plus y square plus 2xy is equal to z square. Therefore, x square plus y square plus z square is nothing but x square plus y square minus z square is nothing but x square plus y square minus z square is nothing but minus 2xy. Na? Therefore, in this one, I substitute minus 2xy. Minus 2xy. Similarly, here also, minus 2yz. Minus 2yz. Here also, minus 2zx. Okay, Nama? Here, LCM is what? LCM is what? 2xyz. LCM is what? 2xyz. So, numerator is what? Z. If I take minus common, Z. Here it is x. Here it is y. Here x plus y plus z is equal to 0. Na? Numerator is 0. The entire value will become 0. Therefore, this value is equal to 0. Option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Question number 86. Two men are opposite sides of a tower. They measure the angle of elevation. The top of the tower has 30 and 40 degrees respectively. 30 and 40 degrees respectively. The height of the tower is 50 meters. So, find the distance between the two men. Find the distance between the two men. So, one angle is bottom of 45 degrees. The height of the tower is 50 meters. So another angle is 30 degrees. They are asking the distance between the two men. The distance between the two men. So this is 45 degrees. Some tan 45. 1. 1 by 1 is nothing but this part is also 50. This part is also what? 50. Now this part I need tan 30. So tan 30 is nothing but 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3 is equal to. So 50 by some x. This one I assume some x. Therefore, x is equal to 50 root 3. X is equal to 50 root 3. Therefore, this x is equal to 50 root 3 and this is 50. Together, I need 50 plus 50 root 3. 50 plus 50 into 1.732. So, 50 into 1.7 is nothing but approximately that is 17.5 is 85. 85 plus 50, 135. Your answer is more than 135. So, more than 135, only one option is there. 136.5. Option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Question number 87. Find the value of this expression. Sine of x plus y plus sine of x minus y is nothing but 2 sine x cos y minus 2 sine x divided by. So cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y is nothing but 2 cos x cos y minus 2 cos x minus 2 cos x. In the numerator, if I take common 2 sin x, if I take common, then what happened? Cos y minus 1. Cos y minus 1. In the denominator, if I take common 2 cos x, then I will get cos y minus 1. Cos y minus 1, cos y minus 1 get cancelled. 2 get cancelled. Therefore, sin x by cos x is equal to tan x. So your answer is what am I tan x? Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 88. If 4 cot theta is equal to 3, if 4 cot theta is equal to 3, then find the value of this expression. So cot theta is equal to 3 by 4. Cot theta is equal to what? 3 by 4. Cot theta is equal to 3 by 4. If cot theta is equal to 3 by 4, adjacent side is 3, opposite side is 4. Hypotenuse is 5. Then sin theta. Sin theta is equal to 4 by 5. 4 by 5 minus cos theta is equal to 3 by 5. By 4 by 5 plus 3 by 5. 4 by 5 plus 3 by 5. LCM is what am I? 5 get cancelled. So 4 minus 3, 1, 1 by 7. 1 by 7. Option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 89. The angle made by the line x plus root 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. Then find the positive direction of x axis. So they're asking angle. m is equal to n tan theta is equal to minus x coefficient by y coefficient, that is nothing but minus a by b. So here minus a by b minus 1 by root 3. When tan become minus 1 by root 3, amma? When tan is 150, theta is 150 degrees. Because tan 150, tan 150, tan 180 minus 30 is nothing but tan 30, 1 by root 3. But 150 is in second quadrant, tan become negative. So when tan become minus 1 by root 3 is nothing but 150 degrees. Chalaman 30 degrees anukunta, that is wrong. So 150 degrees is the right answer. Option B, minus undi kada. So how to add? So 150 degrees. Tan 150 degrees is nothing but tan 180 minus 30. Tan 30 minus tan 30 minus tan 30 is nothing but minus 1 by root 3. So option B is the right answer. Question number 90. A line passes through the point 3,5 and make an angle of 135 degrees with the x-axis. The equation of the line is, just substitute this point in which equation. Which equation satisfies, then that is the line. So substitute and A. So first one, 3 plus 5 minus 8. Yes, this is satisfied. This may be your answer. Second option, so it's not possible. Third one, it's not possible. D also, it's not possible. So option A is the right answer. Just substitute that point. Okay, Nama? That is your answer. Option A is the right answer. Question number 91. A boat takes 19 hours traveling downstream from point A to B and come back to point C. Midway between A and B, the velocity of the stream is 4 km per hour. So, and the speed of the boat in still water is 14 km per hour. Find the distance between A and B. So, A to B downstream and B to C. C is midpoint. B to C. Say for example, A to B is some X. B to C is X by 2. So X by. So downstream na. Downstream is nothing but B plus C. B is what am I? B is 14. C is 4. So together is 18. B plus C. Downstream is nothing but B plus C. Plus. So X by 2 is upstream. B minus C. So 14 minus 4. That 14 minus 4 is nothing but what am I? 10. 10. The total time is what? Total time is 19 hours. Therefore, x by 18 plus x by 20 is equal to 19. So no need to do x value amma. In place of x, what I substitute, then I will it is satisfied. If I put x is equal to 180, because multiple of 18 and 20, common multiple of 18 and 20. So look at me amma. If I substitute 180 by 18, 10 hours. 180 by 20, 9 hours. 10 hours plus 9 hours, 19 hours. Yes, exactly satisfied. So put x is equal to 180. Put x is equal to 180. 180 is nothing but distance between A and B. Na? So option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. In a zoo, there are monkeys and parrots. If heads are counted, these are 450 and legs are counted, these are 1000. How many parrots are there? The question is how many parrots? Therefore, I assume all are monkeys. All are monkeys. Just I already told, wherever they're asking question, assume quite opposite to that one. I assume all are monkeys. All are monkeys is nothing but how many heads are there? So 450 heads are there. Therefore 450 into 4. So that is nothing but 1800. 1800 legs are there. But according to our problem, only 1000 legs are there. And how many extra I counted? 800 legs I counted extra. Each time I counted 2 extra. Therefore 400 times I counted extra. Those 400 are parrots. Those 400 are parrots. So option C is the right answer. Option C is the total 800 legs I counted extra. Every time 2 legs I counted as 4. Every time 2 extra. So 800 by 2 is nothing but 400 times I count extra. Those 400 are the parrots. Therefore parrots are 400. Chennai is a distance of 390 km from Bangalore. A train starts from Bangalore to Chennai at 10 p.m. with a speed of 70 km per hour. Another train starts at Chennai to Bangalore at 11 p.m. with a speed of 90 km per hour. At what distance from Chennai will the two trains cross each other and also find the time when they cross each other? So here, Chennai to Bangalore. Distance is what, Amma? Chennai to Bangalore, distance is what? 390. A train starts from Bangalore. A train starts from Bangalore. Distance is 390. Train starts from Bangalore at 10 p.m. Okay, 10 p.m. At a speed of 70 km per hour. 70 km per hour. Another train starts at Chennai at 11 p.m. At the rate of 90 kilometer per hour. At the rate of 90 kilometer per hour. First of all, at what time they cross each other? So here timings are different. One it is start. One train starts at 10 p.m. Another train starts at 11 p.m. It's not possible to apply relative speed whenever they given different timings. First of all, our duty is to get the both are in the same timings. First of all, I need to convert them into same timings. So this is 10 p.m. now. If I run 1 hour before this one, then 1 hour is nothing but 70 kilometers cross. The remaining should be, if I subtract 70 from 390, the remaining should be 320. Now at 11 o'clock, the distance between the two trains is 320. At 11 o'clock, the distance between the two trains is 320. That 320 by, now I apply relative speed. 320 by relative speed is what? 70, 90, 160. And it will take 2 hours time. So it will take 2 hours time is nothing but after 11 o'clock, it will take 2 hours. After 11 p.m. So after 11 p.m., it will take 2 hours is nothing but, so your answer is what? 1 a.m. So 11 p.m. plus 2 hours is nothing but 1 a.m. See the option sum of 1 a.m. So 1 a.m. with only one option is there. No need to find out the distance also. If you want distance, so they're asking distance. At what distance from Chennai? So Chennai train speed is what am I 90 now? 11 o'clock to 1 a.m. 2 hours now. Speed is 90 na, 90 into 2, 180. The distance is 180 kilometers. So Chennai's train speed is 90. It will take 2 hours time. So 90 into 2, 180. So distance is 180. They meet at exactly 1 a.m. Option C is the right answer. Question number 94. In a test consisting of 250 questions, Jesse answered 40% of the first 125 questions correctly. So what percentage of the other 125 questions does his seat need to answer correctly for the her grand test on the entire exam to be 60%? So finally, he got 60% of the marks. The exam is for 250 questions. He answered 60% of the questions correct. 60% on 250 is nothing but total 150 correct. Total 150 correct. 60% of 250. Total 150 I need to correct. So first 125 questions. In the first 125 questions, how much percent correct am I? 40%. 40% of 125. 10% is nothing but 10. 12.5. 40% is nothing but 50. In the first section, 50 questions are correct. Therefore, I need to correct. In the second section, 100 I need to correct out of 125. So I need to correct 100. So 100 by 125. So 100 by 125 is nothing but 25 fours are 25 fives are. 4 by 5. So 4 by 5 is nothing but 80%. In the second section, I need to correct 80% of the questions. So option B is the right answer. Question number 95. 7 to the power of 82 plus 3 to the power of 41 is divided by 26. Find the remainder will be how much? So 7 to the power of 82. So this one I am going to written as, so 49 whole to the power of 41. This one I am going to written as 7 square whole to the power of 49. 7 square is nothing but 49. 7 square whole to the power of 41. 7 square is nothing but 49. Okay, nama 49 whole to the power of 41. Plus 3 to the power of 41. Okay, nama. So here, a power n plus b power n is completely divisible by a plus b where n is odd. Look at me, Amma. A plus B is 52 na. A plus B is what? 52. So 52 is completely divisible by 26 na. Definitely na. Therefore, remainder will be 0 na. Yes or na? Remainder will be 0. So option D is the right answer. Question number 96 to 100. They given data interpretation, Amma. So the given table shows the students' performance in 10th standard over the years. So observe the table and answer the following questions. They given grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. So how many students are there and failure students, number of students? Okay, Namma. So total 120, say for example 2010, total 120 students are there. Okay, Namma. So grade 1 passed out are 20, grade 2 is 30, grade 3 is 45, failure students are 25. If you add 50, 95 plus 25, 120. Okay, Namma. Now read the first question. D. The fail percentage is comparatively high in which year? So here fail percentage is nothing but 25 by 120. Here fail is nothing but 30 by 150. Here 40 by 190. They given 2010, 2011, 2012, 2013. No need to calculate 2014. So 25 by 210. So which fraction is the highest one? Amma, if you observe, this is 10% is 12, 20% is 24. So greater than 20% is, and very very closer to 20%. Yes or not? Very closer to 20 and more than 20. This is exactly 20%. This is exactly 10% is 15, 20% is 30. Exactly 20. This is more than 20. So I need to cancel this one. They're asking high in which year, comparative high in which year. So first, second option I need to cancel. 2011 I need to cancel. Next 45. Amma, 10% how much and 19? 20% and 38. 20% 38. This is also more than 20%. Now 25 by 210, 10% 21. It is less than 20. This is less than 20. So last one is also cancelled. 2013 is also cancelled. So my answer is either 2010 or 2012. This is 25 by 120. So 1 by 12 extra is there. But here 2 by 19. So 2 by 19 is the more one comparatively. So here if I take 20% is 24. I need only 1 by 12. 1 by 12 is nothing but, so it's very less. So here if I take 20%, that is 38. Remainder is 2 by 19, definitely more than that one. So second one option is correct answer. So option C, 2012, it is higher one. Karanam check chesukochu andi. So 2500 by 120 into 100 undi kabatti ikkada 4000 by 190. If you calculate, then we will get the exact one. So option C is the right answer. So 96 option is option C. In 2011, the percentage of grade 1 students is how much? In 2011. So 2011, grade 1 students. Out of 150, 25 is how much percentage? So 25 by 150. But 25 by 150 is nothing but 1 by 6. 1 by 6 is nothing but 16.66. So your answer is 16.66. So option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Question number 98. The percentage of rise of grade 1 students from 2010 to 2014. Grade 1, 2010 to 2014. So 20 become 60, 2010 to 2014. So how much rise? Into 400 rise. So 400 rise on 200. Sorry. 40 rise. 40 rise, 20 become 60, 40 rise on 20. So 40 by 20 is nothing but 2. So 2 is nothing but 200%. How much percent rise am I? 200%. So option D is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Question number 99. The ratio of grade 3 students in 2012 to 2014. The ratio of grade 3 students in 2012 to 2014. So grade 3 students. Grade 3 and third one. Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. Third one. 2012 to 2014. 2012 to 2014. 2012 is what am I? 60. 2012 is what am I? 60. So this one is what? 80. 2014 is what? 18. So 60 is to 80. 60 is to 80 is nothing but what am I? 3 is to 4. 3 is to 4. Grade 3. 3 is to 4. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. 99, option A is the right answer. Question number 100. The grade 2 percentage is high in which year? The grade 2 percentage. Grade 2 percentage is high in which year? Grade 2 percentage. Okay, Nama? They're asking grade 2 percentage high in which year? Grade 2 percentage high in which year, Amma? So first one, it is what? 30 by 120. Next one is what? So they given 4 options only na. So A option 14, 13, 12, 10. 10 ivvaledu. 2010 ivvaledu. 2010 cheyalsinatuvanta option avasaram ledu. So 2010 cheyalsinatuvanta avasaram ledamma. So 11, 25 by 150. Grade 2 kada. Ten, there is no option. First of all, calculate 11, 12, 13, 14. So 40 by 150. Next one is what? So 55 by 190. Next one is what? 60 by 210. 60 by 210. Next is what? 80 by 230. Sorry, 75 by 230. 75 by 230. They're asking which one is higher one. Which one is higher one? So that 40 by 150, 55 by 190, 60 by 210, 75 by 230. So which one is the higher one? They're asking which one is the higher one. Which here is the highest one? So in this one, which one is the higher one? If I take this one, Amma, if you observe, this is less than 30%. 93 just less than 30%. If I take, this is also less than 30%. but this is greater than 30%, because 10% 23, 30% 69, but I need 75. This is more than 30, less than 30, because 30% is 63, less than 30, because 30% is 57, less than 30, because 30% is 45. So your answer is what? Last one is nothing but 2014. Last one is 2014 only, na? So option A is the right answer.